So the team's about to step onto the ice. Young Maddie Rooney will lead out the US squad. Here come Canada. So the teams hit the ice with just over 3 minutes to go, and we have a gold medal game for Canada and the US. The big cheers go up as the blue-shirted Americans hit the ice. Plenty of fans from both nations in this to see the most important meeting of these two sides in 4 years.
Well, one of the biggest flavors to this competition is not only are they the best, but their support from their traveling fans here in abundance in Pyeongchang. They are very enthusiastic. They are very supportive of their respective sides. There you look at Zavadas, 31 years of age. And they give us the suggestion as though she will get the nod. It's an interesting one, as at the other end, it's more clear. Maddie Rooney takes her position, but is there, it's a little bit of a gamesmanship here. You do almost have to wonder.
Very interesting. Well, we were certainly told that Lacasse was going to get the start. That was the indication, even in warm-ups, with Zavadas staying on the ice way, way beyond that. And Marie-Philippe Poulon there going to see her teammates. The gold medal game seems made for her. Megan Duggan is the captain of Team USA.
It's a very interesting situation as we look at the referees. Hertrich is the German referee, Tim Glass from Sweden. On the line, Linick and Turainen from Germany and Finland. This is their best honor to be here in charge of the gold medal game. As the teams leave their respective goal nets, it is at the one end Rooney that stays in, and at the other end, it is, as they look to each other right now, in the Canadian goal, it's going to be Zavadas who gets the start. And it's so curious that we're right down to the final seconds before that's determined. Rob Stauber, in his first Olympic Games, in charge of this American side. Is he a difference, potentially, to get the Americans up over the hump?
Melody Dio leads the team in scoring with 3 goals and 3 assists. For USA, Dani Camoranesi has got 3+2 in her 4 games so far.
Megan Augusta, now 4 Olympic Games. This is a moment for both of these sides and the players to take command.
Last look at the netminders, who will be the key competitors as we get underway into the gold medal game. It's Canada against USA. We're in the Gangneung Hockey Center, women's ice hockey. Gold is up for grabs. Here we go then, Decker and Poulin face off to get us underway in this gold medal game. The 8th time in the Olympics these two teams have met. Canada hold the 5-2 advantage in games one, including those gold medal victories. It's 20 years since the US managed to get the gold medal out of the grips of Canada, but that was in the very first games back in Nagano. We have a veteran of that Nagano tournament involved in this game, Canadian coach Laura Schuler, was a player on the losing side, the silver medalists in Nagano 20 years ago. We come forward with USA. It's cut out by Rebecca Johnson in neutral ice for Team Canada. Rooney and Zavadas, the starting netminders. We were having mind games with the Canadian netminding situation. Lacasse, who played so well against USA, an incredible game from Lacasse against USA in the round robin to win it by 2-1, including a nice penalty save from a shot from Jocelyn Lamoureux. A cheeky attempt by Jocelyn Lamoureux. Lacasse was on the top of the sheet. She was taking lots of reps in the practice session. She was assumed to be the starter in this one. And Zabadosso gets the nod. And I just wonder if those mind games on us penetrated into the locker room and kept the US team guessing as well. Opening stages of the game, neither netminder troubled so far. Maddie Rooney in the US net just watches that one go behind, and a cagey opening.
It certainly has been. Both of these sides, they're going to feel each other out as the Americans look to make a good move here.
It's Lamoureux on the ice. The Lamoureux sisters have been very potent in this tournament so far. Both of them been very sharp around the goal. And this is Monique, number 7, looking for Jocelyn, 17.
Yeah, this combination of the two Lamoureux sisters for the United States are as dynamic, of course, a sibling connection as you're going to have in women's ice hockey.
That was Steckline making the clearance before a line change for Team USA, and Dio is on for Canada. A couple of touches on Dio from the fast skating. Well, we're definitely going to see the... I mean, we saw one of the great matches of this tournament, in fact, one of the best ever matches between these two sides down the years in the group stage, which was a 2-1 victory for Canada. And it was really a trip. If this can come anywhere near matching that, we've got a great match on our hands.
What a story for Laura Schuler, who, as you say, a member of the Canadian team that, unfortunately, as it is in team sports, they end up losing a silver medal or losing in the gold game, and you get yourself a silver medal. It's such a hard thing to have to admit to. Here he is.
Oh, chance. And it looked for a moment like there might be a trip. Well, I think we both looked to the referees to see if there was any raised arms, but nothing given on that. It'd be interesting to see how the European officiating crew calls this one. A chance for Canada, trying to make the move in front of the goal was Melody Dio, but she had no help. She had to go her own way. But Canada still have possession, and it's a attempted cross pass to Rebecca Johnson. Johnson does pick it up eventually. Johnson out there with Jenna. We're looking for her line mate because there might have been a switch here. Yes, Saulnier is off this line. Wakefield is in. Wakefield then, they've broken up the Calgary Inferno line that played so well. Wakefield plays over in Sweden, and she's joined this line, which has been very good so far. Jenna and especially Rebecca Johnson have had good tournaments, and Canada still coming in waves now as they get the first real pressure on goals. A wraparound attempt there from Turnbull, but it's saved by Maddie Rooney.
Good direct line hockey from the Canadians to start this gold medal game. This coming behind the goal by Turnbull. She elects to take it all the way. She drags it, and it's always a good play to take the puck to the net because anything can happen. A strong, powerful move. But there, on the post, is Rooney to match it for the Americans for the faceoff.
Turnbull, Irwin, and Spooner. Another new-look line for Team Canada. We'll try and preserve this attacking momentum. And this is Irwin, who's been used predominantly on a power play specialist role in this tournament so far, but appears in this tournament that they're using her greater experience to give her this line with Spooner and Turnbull. We'll have to see how that develops, because Spooner in particular has been making things happen when she's on the ice for Canada. USA solid as a rock, playing exactly the way they have all tournament, not mixing up any of the lines, keeping it as you were. Because so far, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, I think is the USA team motto. Canada, though, with the better of the possession so far, and with that first chance on goal as well. So we have a look at Rob Stauber and the US coaching staff. Stauber himself, a former goalie, and he's put his faith in the 20-year-old Maddie Rooney throughout this tournament, more or less. I mean, we've had some other moments for the other netminders, but it's been Rooney who's been his starter.
Well, she's got wonderful pedigree at world championship level. She's already a world champion in women's ice hockey, but it's the Olympic gold medal. Is she ready to get her nation and such an important position in the sport of ice hockey, as we all know, goalkeeping. They can be the difference, and they can be the hero. And is there a display between these two, Bruni and Zavidas, against each other? The Canadians elect to go with experience in Zavidas. They've made a few other adjustments, but in goal, they're going to go with what they know.
It's a broad generalization, but it's actually a true generalization, is that Canada win gold at the Olympics, don't they? And USA win the World Championships. It's pretty much been the pattern over the last decade or so. In fact, since 1990, every World Championship gold medal game has been between these two teams, with USA having by far the better of those games. But it's a chance in front of the net and a little scramble in front there, a little poke away from Megan Agosta, but Rooney is firm again.
Interestingly, we're over 5 minutes gone in this game, and it hasn't felt as yet as though an underbelly of tension is in this game, meaning they're not necessarily trying to prove against each other physically. They're trying to play the puck, trying to play the game properly and straight. They do not want to get into penalty trouble.
It was very, very hard hitting in the group game as Coyne uses her speed to turn on the Jets down the right wing. Again, we've seen it. Super burst of speed from Kendall Coyne. She goes back and finds support eventually from Casey Bellamy. But Bellamy's pass forward is a little loose and it will be gathered by Canada. It's in neutral ice now with Hillary Knight. Hillary Knight just knocks that one out to Decker. It's a chance on the right-hand side across the face of Zabados' net. Zabados getting the start. We were wondering whether Lacasse might be in with a shout, and certainly there were moments when we thought she would get the start. We were certainly led to believe that by some of the media information that came out before the game, but it's now Spooner for Canada. Look at the way Spooner gets forward there, flashes that one across the face of the net. Turnbull was in there, so was Irwin, but it was away, and a chance goes begging for Canada. 13:48 to go, two shots in on Rooney so far. Canada, though, with the best of the match. We have a scoreline, though, of Canada and USA, nothing.
Natalie Spooner with this play across the face of goal shows you that she's got game breakability. She's a kind of player in a game like this. We've seen it throughout the tournament where one-on-one in individual situations, she can create space, she can create options for her teammates, and with some speed and skating ability, she drives wide. And we'll have a look at it here as both teams use this opportunity, of course, to encourage each other, to, of course, emphasize the points in preparation ahead of this game. That's quite a teaching formation going on in the Canadian bench right now, as Stauber, a little more stoic with his arms crossed, and feels as though his message has been imparted and that his team understands exactly what it is that they need to do.
Dio out on the ice with Poulin and Agosta for Team Canada. As for USA, they've got out the Amanda Kessel line along with Cameron Azey and Brandt. Not a talent on that particular trio of forwards. This is Keller. Keller lines one up. It's a deflection past the goal. Good work in front of the net by USA's Danny Camoranesi. Camoranesi, 3+2 in the tournament so far, leading the team in goal scoring for the USA, who are wearing their slightly less familiar blue outfit for this. It's the Canadians as the de facto home team in this game, who are wearing the very familiar white jerseys with the maple leaf on the front and the red flashes on the arm. And Spooner is back on the ice. We mentioned her just a moment ago. Things happen when Spooner hits the ice for Canada, the number 24 player to watch.
Well, equally for the United States, it took a while before we noticed Amanda Kessel in this hockey game. She is a threat for the Americans. She'll need to be sharp. We saw Hillary Knight is now the Americans are flirting with just getting possession. But Hillary Knight made a good individual one-on-one play earlier too. That's important for American offensive confidence.
Hillary Knight had a very good semi-final game for USA. She'd had a quiet tournament up until that stage. Well, quiet by her very high standards. Let's be absolutely clear about that. Hillary Knight is an excellent player with a fantastic shot. And she really did play a big part in the big semi-final victory that got USA here. They absolutely handled Finland with a 5-0 win. And they come forward here. USA, good work across the net. Zabados is tested again. And it's a wraparound chance. That was great work from Gigi Marvin. Both sides of the net for Marvin. But Zabados able to make the stop. Good defensive work there by Rebecca Johnson, but USA still have it. Just under 11 and a half minutes to go in the first period. And here come USA again. Zabados with a glove save in front of the mask, and it stays scoreless here at the Guangdong Hockey Center.
It's been a very workwoman-like performance from both of these sides in the opening stages, as we're now in the 8 minute to play. A shot here using through the screen, always an effective tactic. And then Gigi Marvin with a opportunity. This is panic rather on the reverse angle, but good movement from USA.
Yes, USA now outshooting Canada 4-2. Canada having the best of the opening stages, but it's Agosta there who backhands it in front of the net. Snubbed out quickly by USA, and here's Kendall Coyne. Kendall Coyne down that wing is such an effective attacking option, but Canada come back the other way, and it's actually a 3-on-2 break for Team Canada. In on Rooney. Rooney makes a save, lifted up her glove, and here's the first little battle around the net, and it's Poulin involved in there with Keller, and a bit of pushing and shoving. Hillary Knight in there as well. It comes to nothing, as does the attack. Megan Agosta playing her fourth Olympic Games.
This was probably the best chance so far for Canada with the odd player break, and Poulin moves it across to Agosta. It was just a little bit of an overhandle here, where it really, as the American defender comes back to take it away.
2+2 in the tournament for Agosta. As I say, playing her fourth games, turned 31 at the start of these Olympics. So a fifth isn't out of the question. Slotting in alongside Poulam and Dayu in this Canadian forward line, but it's Wakefield on the ice now. There's a big hit on the boards there. The arm goes up straight away. Wakefield goes to the ground, and Wakefield will go to the penalty box. We'll go with USA's power play for the next 2 minutes or less, as Wakefield gets this for an illegal hit.
It's a penalty because the American player has the right to play the puck and continue that line. Yes, Wakefield had already established it, but she, because of her strength and because of her ability to stun the American player, it was too obvious, and they get penalized as a result.
So it's Bellamy looking for the big shot on the blue line with Sydney Morin. The youngster Morin, 22 years old, with an assist already in this tournament, given a real vote of confidence by being put on this first power play line, as that shot went just past the post. Good effort from Brianna Decker on the power play. 10 minutes to go in this period. More importantly, right now for USA and Canada, there are 90 seconds left on this US power play. Coyne, Knight and Decker on the ice. Knight is offside when she receives the puck, and there's a player down. Bellamy's back on her skates, so, and we'll restart this one with 1:25 left on the power play, and a line change for USA.
The Americans look really good on this power play, driving the net, taking this on the back end, a quick shot. That's a legitimate goal scoring opportunity there for Decker.
Decker from the Boston Pride. No goals but two assists in the tournament for the number 14.
That's a great net drive. That's the most important part. Even though you get the player advantage, still play the game straight, and that's what the Americans have done so far.
Slightly loose at the back there from Falzer, but we're back underway. And we're back on the forward dash from Keller for USA, with just under 70 seconds now to go on this power play opportunity. USA have it. Zabados looking to both sides of her net because she can see the danger over on the right and the free skater, Megan Keller. If she can get the puck here, but no, it's a big shot from Bowser from the blue line. Another confidence-boosting grab by Shannon Zabados.
It is. As you watch this whole play develop here, Bowser takes the shot, but in the most, there isn't an American player in front, is there? You need to be in the eyes of Zabados there. And off to the side of goal is not effective enough. A little too late by the Americans to get in front.
But they maintain the pressure on the Canadian net throughout this power play. Steckline now with it. Touch from Monique Lamoureux. His panic is out there again. Jocelyn Lamoureux back to Steckline. Jocelyn Lamoureux with the low shot. Her sister Monique was in front of the net looking for the tip cross. Zabados, as you said, they were on that occasion creating traffic around the net, but it's bashed away by Canada, and 15 seconds remaining on this power play for USA. It's Lamoureux again. Pass Jocelyn Lamoureux back to Steckline. It just bobbles over the stick and out of the zone. That's pretty much killed that power play. And there'll be a change of lines as we regroup back to 5-on-5 hockey, and Hillary Knight bursts forward with the big shot. Just past the power post and takes a big bounce off the boards behind. Hillary Knight can really get some power behind that big shot of hers. It was wide this time. And here come Canada with a good dash up the ice. Well, what a great move that was from Renata Fast, very nearly creating a chance on goal. She's out there with Augusta. And this has fallen to Dayu. Dayu tries to make a move inside, but in fact wheels around and gets some support just out of reach, though, of Jenna. Jenna picks it up and gets it back, and Dayu shoots just past the post. The big bounce back. Well, that was a real miscue for the US, and Augusta has it shot. Jenna really bothering Rooney here and trying to get driven away from the net, but this is Canada who, well, the official gets in the way of that one. As Laquette got forward there, and we have Jocelyn Laroque now coming in, shooting, it's charged away. Wakefield tries to bash that one away and sustain pressure from Canada here.
It's been their best shift of the hockey game so far. They've had breaks on attack, they've come out of the corner, they've come from behind the net, they've had shots to the blue line, they're starting to show their pedigree, the Canadians, in this shift. But they're gonna take a penalty. Canada are gonna get it, 2 minutes for interference here, and it's back-to-back power plays, the United States of America. This looms large right now in a scoreless game. And you can see by the expression on their coach's face, Laura Schuler, this feels like a momentum shift. Canada just had their best shift of the hockey game. They were doing everything right. They really probably should have scored. But now they find themselves down a player as there is the penalty for interference in the neutral zone. And this feels, as you so often can, as this was the great feed from Jenner onto the blue line and the shot from Rougeau. But you can get a sense in a hockey game when danger is knocking on your door, and the Americans right now have got a wonderful opportunity in which to step forward and grab the first goal of the game.
So second power play opportunity for Team USA. Kessel, but it's clear straight away. Jocelyn Laroque is in for 2 minutes. Laroque from the Markham Thunder, her defensive partnership with Bridget Laquette from Calgary Inferno has been key to Canada in this tournament, but that will be split up for the time being as that little effort goes past the bar from Danny Camoranesi. And it's going to be away. And this is very good work on the penalty kill. from Canada and the youngster, Laura Stacey. They've got the youngsters on the ice to get this penalty kill sorted, with Nurse also out there, along with Bailey Bram, I believe, for the first time getting on the ice for this game. Bailey Bram, another youngster. So they got the kids out there along with Laura Fortino to kill this penalty, and they've done very well in the first minute of that. It's Bellamy. Shot blocked, though, before it can get down to Zabados. 5:30 left in the period, 45 seconds left on the power play for USA. But this one has just not clicked for the team in blue. This is Bellamy to Decker. Can Decker get forward here? Decker twists and turns. Great work from Decker. Nice move to get past her marker. But another Canadian stick comes in. This time it is Emily Clark, another one of the young new faces in the Canadian lineup, playing her first Olympic Games. Clark makes a key interception. And 15 seconds now remain on the power play. It looks like no dice this time around for Team USA, unless they can swing that in front. It goes all the way back. This one's over.
Well, Decker had to shoot the puck. She was in a position in which to score from there. It was going to be tough to beat Zabados. She makes an extra pass. Nothing happens. And the penalty's over. And they've lost their little bit of momentum. But they're coming back here, resurging. The Canadians are very resilient. And they're going to stay the course here and just try to get that puck back again and go assert themselves offensively.
So 0-2 on the power play. General scoring and the power play, both factors that US needed to look at. For Canada, they do have big scoring for coach Laura Shuler. 14 returnees going for their fifth gold medal. 14 players back from Sochi, the team that won gold in overtime against USA 4 years ago. And what a game that was. This one, as expected, also super close, as Rougeau comes back, wrap around, takes the outside of the post, and a big clash and skaters falling to the ice is 4 minutes to go, and the long, long shot, pass shot down the ice, unable to be gathered by Amanda Pelkey for Team USA.
Well, Rougeau on the blue line for Canada is an offensive threat. She got the feed from Wakefield, I believe, just a moment ago before they took the penalty. She takes this puck in behind the goal. Daou's a player who can individually beat you one against one. But the Canadian blue liners also can bring the offense, as we still are scoreless inside of 4 minutes in this first period. There's a different feeling, not that you can taste it, but there is a sense from the Americans that if they were to score a goal first here, would that do something incredibly for their confidence? Of course it would. Of course Canada wants to score first, but this is an American side that has to get over the mental hurdle in this gold medal match of the Olympic Games, and a first goal would start.
Second time around in these Olympic Games for these two sides. Scoreless so far, with just under 4 minutes to go in the first period. We've had both teams with their chances. Shots on goal, 7-5 in favor of USA right now. We've had those two power play opportunities, but their power play, well, the second one in particular, just didn't quite work out for them. Penalty kill was strong as Wakefield gets the shot. It's blocked straight away. And it's a good piece of work from Casey Bellamy, the number 22.
She's a very sharp and clean shooter as Wakefield. She'll shoot through a screen. That one gets muffled down by the American defense, as both of these teams are equally committed to blocking shots in front of their keepers.
This is Bellamy, gets it forward. This is Kendall Coyne in towards Hillary Knight. Hillary Knight just takes it away and gets some time to pick her pass down in the corner under little pressure, but it's away by Canada. And a chance at the other end, another long-range shot from Irwin. Irwin, though, goes in there because I think that the puck was dropped by Rooney, and Irwin was quite right to make the chase down and try to get the rebound herself, and she's got the puck with Poulin now. This is Poulin back to Daou. Daou with Agosta. It was Daou there doing her best to try and get in on goal, but that shot from Hillary Knight is blocked, and away comes Agosta, and it's so close to connecting with Turnbull there on the inside.
It's a very smart idea there from Agosta, trying to get it to Turnbull. It's a very fine pass. If you get it on, you can catch the gap and maybe shoot through the American defense.
Shot against the outside of the post, but guarded very closely by Zabados. It came from the USA, who come again. But Turnbull, she loses out on this one. So US have it through Lamoureux. Lamoureux goes to her right-hand side. That cross shot, Zabados spills it just briefly. A little bit of a pile-up in front of the net, but we'll go to a face-off with 1:46 to go.
And you see right there, you see the Lamoureux sisters. They are as intense and as focused a pair of athletes as the Americans have, as this is an overload and then a shot here from a sharp angle, a deflection late in front, and then Lamoureux comes right there and drops the Canadian defenseman. This is Marie-Philippe Poulin, and then it's loose change, and she tries to put it right in the pocket, but she can't convert.
Yes, it's Poulin on the big burst forward. She will go into this game as captain this time of Canada, absolutely full of confidence, knowing that gold medal games are her property. We're going to the power play once again. We'll have a first look at things as we have a call on.
It's going to be Nurse.
Nurse goes, and that gets a lot of boos inside the rink, and a wry smile from the bench from Laura Schuler. Nurse has gone for 2 minutes.
Well, Pelkey lost her stick in the play. Let's watch it here. That's an interference call against. Yeah, that's going to be it. That's going to be one. Now, Pelkey a little bit light on control of the stick. Nurse, powerful, athletic in her first Olympic Games. What a pedigree her family has in sport. But she chops too hard down, and it's an easy call.
So, unless there's a goal, USA will see out the period on the power play. With Nurse gone for interference at 18:26, a third power play of the period for USA. But still no goals on the scoreboard at the Gangneung Hockey Centre. Cleared by Canada.
And that's a massive first attempt clearance by the Canadians. They have been on the back foot with the player disadvantage throughout the course of this opening period. That one, fortunately for them, pops into the bench, gives them a little bit of respite inside of a minute remaining in the opening 20. But there's been a consecutive three calls against the Canadians here that every time the Americans go into power play, they're of course getting closer to scoring their goal.
What are you going to wear to the hockey game, dear? I think I'll go.
As
Uncle Sam. It's into the final minute. We're on the power play with USA for the third time in this game. Casey Bellamy looking for the big shot behind. But this one, though, comes from the right-hand side. And Morin, Sydney Morin with Casey Bellamy, the two blue liners on this one. Morin goes inside this time, makes her way down through the face-off circle, wheels around the net, just lays that one off, and she's got the puck back now. Looking for the shot, it's tipped in front, and it's there! Morin had the shot, it was tipped in front by Hillary Knight, and on the power play, USA lead with 25 seconds to go in the first period by 1-0. Hillary Knight with the goal.
It's a massive goal. The leading goal in a hockey game of this magnitude, the percentage is highly in favor of the team that get it first to win the game. Hillary Knight in perfect position. I don't think there's interference. She's just ahead of the blue paint. She gets a touch of the puck, and I think Zabados has every opportunity to play that one there. It's just a fantastic hockey play from the Americans as they execute to perfection with the player advantage. In front, take away the keeper's eyes, execute the shot. Get a touch of it if you can, and USA. A big one.
Wow, first blood US, as we saw in Sochi 4 years ago as well. But credit goes to the youngster, 22-year-old Sydney Moran, getting the time on the power play, plays her hockey in Europe, and what a great piece of work it was for her to just get the shot in on goal after creating all that space for herself. Great work from the youngster, lovely tip from Hillary Knight, and for Hillary Knight, well, she has certainly had a lively end to this tournament. Have another look at this one, her second of the tournament from the Boston Pride, Hillary Knight, at number 21.
It's a double whammy as you see Knight in front. They score in a power play and they score in the last minute of period when Canada may have thought they could have slipped out of the opening 20 and got away with some of the dangerous self-imposed penalties that they have taken. They haven't. The Americans finally find a way on this power play and Knight does her job. A big, imposing physical presence for the USA in front of the goal.
And there is the buzzer for the end of 20 minutes and USA have the edge. They score late in the power play. They lead the gold medal game over Canada by 1-0. So big celebrations here. It's not over yet, but they're celebrating. A little bit of a celebration around the net, because it's a huge goal, isn't it?
It was, and that's curious to just see that characteristic from the Americans, the way they came around the goal. It was almost like a reconsolidation of what their game plan was from the dressing room, bringing it out onto the ice, and then following it through. And then they almost came back together and reconfirmed the message of what they're trying to achieve as a group of 22 players in this particular game. You've got Schuler, the Canadian coach, disputing the call, and unfortunately, whether we like it or not, that's negative energy for the Canadian dressing room, because all their players have gone back now to review what's just gone on here, and they've got their coach who's feeling aggrieved. They've got to cut their losses there, Canada, and get back to work and reset the decks.
So here's how it started, with Lacasse and Zabados having some fun around the net, as did the US team at the other end. And we got underway with Canada having the best of the opening opportunities. And this one, in particular from Blair Turnbull, very close to testing Rooney in the early stages. And we also had a shot here from Dayu. We've had a tip in front of the net from Dayu, and Augusto also involved in that one.
They've had better chances. They've had better chances here. Spooner across in front. That was a real dangerous one for the Americans to contend with. As then coming back the other direction, it's the U.S.
Kelly Paddock for that one.
And from here, Augusta could have maybe made better of that. They almost delayed a little too late as the Americans took it back with a little bit of a chop on the stick. And then the Americans, they got more and more comfortable. That was the shot earlier in the period from Brianna Decker. And then Lamoureux. Before this goal, there was an important and very interesting little play. Lamoureux knocked down the Canadian defenseman Rougeau in front. It was, they were contesting for one of these loose pucks. As you see the battle going on here, Poulin trying to get to it. Poulin took the shot, was following it up, but they punctuated that precise move with the goal. And that is massive for the confidence of the Americans. Right here. And it's little things. But when you're playing the games between these two sides, there is not much to choose between them. So yes, little things. Well, they amount to big things come the end of 60 minutes.
And after 20, we have the edge to USA over Canada. They lead this one by the single goal after one period. Scoreline of Canada nothing, USA one. We're at the Gangneung Hockey Centre. We are one third of the way through the gold medal game, and we have a breakthrough after Decker fed Morin. Morin did so well skating around the goal, finding her shooting opportunity. And there was Hillary Knight right in front of the goal. Knight's second goal of the tournament. But what a huge little, the most delicate of touches in front of the goal. It was really great from Hillary Knight. And she gets her second and crucially makes the breakthrough for US, who have outshot Canada in spite of Canada's early play. And they kind of ran into penalty trouble. And USA finally making the breakthrough late in the period. And probably, you know, with all those penalties conceded by Canada, maybe USA just deserving to shade it after 20.
I think they did. And, you know, you get that many consecutive opportunities. They had 5 minutes and 8 seconds on the power play. Canada had nothing. Now, that's not simply just luck. You create your own luck. And then the Canadians also maybe shooting themselves in the foot. And it's a very fair result for Americans to be up by 1-0 with that much time. They had some good hockey play, equally so of the Canadians. There were chances where the Canadians should have scored, even strength, they did not. And unfortunately, they haven't been awarded with the bonus of extra time or an extra skater on the ice. They haven't had that advantage as yet. So going into that intermission break for the Canadians, they gotta dig deep, because one goal might not seem like much, but in a tournament and in a game between these two sides, it's a big deal. And momentum right now is fully with the Americans. Canada have got to respond in the opening 5 minutes of this second period.
Shannon Sabados in net for Canada. She's beaten once in the first period by Hillary Knight's tip in front of goal. Her third point of the tournament. Of course, she's played in all five games. And Knight coming quick and coming good at the end of the sharp end of this tournament. Megan Agosta with chances for Canada. Agosta's fourth Olympic Games, the experienced leader of this side. Here we go then, second of the three, and it's Keller, number five, uprooted there and goes absolutely flying. The ice time leader, Megan Keller, was flattened there, well off the puck, but we carry on with Team Canada. And this is Megan Agosta with the shot. There's the effort from the right-hand side and Team Canada. Looking at some of these stats after the first period, it was Renata Fast with 7.5 minutes on the ice who led the ice time. There's also over 7 minutes for Jocelyn Larocque. And as I say, it was Megan Keller who got hit here with 7:54 on the ice.
Keller and Poulin run into each other here. And in fairness, Keller is lucky not to have been penalized, because I think she stays in the line of Marie-Philippe Poulin in that situation. It's shades of gray, but this is now the Canadians with control in the opening minute in the offensive zone.
Larocque over to Lequet. That's the shot back off the boards. Good one as well, because it got a nice little bit of a rebound there, but it didn't quite fall back to Rebecca Johnson in time, and Larocque sets things away again. She'll have a second chance to do so here. It's in neutral ice, but it's a breakout chance. And this is, wow, Kessel with a big shot. As she burst in there again, turning on the jet, showing a great burst of speed, and Kessel's back on the puck now. Good effort.
Oh, it's a very threatening shot because the puck was rolling as well, and she's got that deftness of touch. She's very slippery, is Kessel. She's got the puck now.
Hannah Brandt sends it back to Kessel. It just took a little bit of a deflection in front of the net there. Hannah Brandt calls in the obstruction, and Zabados had to be sharp there to try and stop the puck, which the heat had been taken out. It was sort of an off-speed in front of Zabados' net. And Cameron Azey for USA. 3+2 in the tournament so far for the youngster out of the University of Minnesota. Here come Canada pushing forward.
Oh,
what a goal! What a goal. Oh, it's incredible. It's right in front of the net. And did Hayley Owen get the touch on that? Wow, a great burst forward. And I think maybe out of midair, Owen coming in at the near post with the tying goal. Turnbull involved in the action. Great work from Turnbull taking her own pass off the boards. The cross there, I can't believe it. If Irwin got the touch on that one, we'll see from the next angle. That's a super goal.
Pretty sure she has, as she gets a stick to it, and it's just enough to elude past Rooney. And the Canadians, wow, what a response inside the opening 2 minutes here in the second period. It's gonna count. And it's level at one.
Well, what a piece of work from Hayley Irwin, right on the goalpost. The time of the goal, 22 exactly. Irwin from Turnbull, it's 1-1. Irwin's third point of the tournament.
And a penalty coming up here for the Canadians right back. So what an incredible moment there, and sorry to come across, because Canada have again shot themselves in the foot potentially here.
Right now, though, it's looking like a piece of genius from Laura Schuler here, because Hayley Irwin, in this tournament so far, has been almost used exclusively on the power play line. She's been given more regular shifts on a line in this. Poulin goes to the penalty box for 2 minutes for tripping, but Irwin has pulled this game back level, and we're back underway. We're back on the power play with Team USA, just as Canada get back in front, and they get back into the game, as you say, with that tying goal from Irwin. It's the youngsters out there. Megan Mickelson will be the experienced campaigner at the start of this power play. Jenna also with some experience out there with LaRocque, and Stacey is the other penalty killer.
That just left the surface of play for a moment. It went off the American player just in the bench, and that's the reason for the stoppage of play. But very interesting, you're right, about Hayley Irwin, without doubt. This is an excellent, simple hockey play. This is a player that goes to net with the idea of trying to make something from nothing. And boy, if they just created a big goal here for Canada, who were against the ropes, in fairness. And they've had a response, but they're going to have to kill this penalty too.
So we're on the power play with USA. Still 80 seconds of the skater advantage for USA, wearing the all blue in this contest as the away side. Sydney Morin, Decker and Knight and Coyne, the three forwards on the power play here. Back on the blue line, waiting for its Casey Bellamy.
And some physicality from the Canadian defense there. First time we've seen a little bit of that extra bit.
Bellamy, it's away by Fast. Coyne has it. Knight in front of goal, in front of Zabados again. And was Zabados unsighted there? She dropped it, and first time around it was eventually away by Canada, but a close call for Zabados.
Bending but not breaking for Canada in front. The Americans with the confidence, with the player advantage here now, asserting themselves.
Hannah Brandt, shot, big rebound off of Zabados from Brandt's effort. Kessel in there now, trying to dig that one out. Keller also on this power play with Cameron Azey. Away by Canada, and that, with just 5 seconds to go on the power play, we'll see that one off, but how much longer can Canada survive shorthanded? They've conceded one power play goal, but they've now spent 8 minutes in the penalty box.
Well, this is the challenge, isn't it? Since each one of these plays is a contest for the puck, 50-50s, one-on-one against the Americans, they've got to be much cleaner than they've been so far, Canada. They are putting extra pressure on themselves, and this is enough of a challenge at this stage of the tournament.
Lovely work from Megan Mickelson there, the number 12, the most experienced member of the Canadian unit. Just so calmly playing that one out of defense, just to sort of ease the pressure off as both teams are now back at full strength. And that's a burst down the ice from Megan Duggan. Nothing really at the end of that one, and Canada come away with it. We've got a tie game here. A goal from Hillary Knight right at the end of the first period, but Hayley Irwin leveling it 2 minutes into the second. The Knight goal coming on the power play, and since then we've had Poulin in the penalty box, but the penalty was killed by Team Canada, who come forward here, and Johnson with the shot, saved by Maddie Rooney.
It's a great save, and of course from there, though, she sees it, although Rebecca Johnson's got some speed behind it, and it's a relatively comfortable save. But we'll just look here at the Americans off this outside. You see the flickering of the hair outside of the helmet. That's showing the speed here. And Johnson, who equally has it for the Canadians with a wrist shot. But Rooney comfortably into the midsection. We talk about those two goals, though. The Irwin goal and the Knight goal are very similar. Bigger players physically present in front of the opposition's goal, getting a slight touch of it late to deflect past the keepers.
Irwin, the goal scorer out there for the face-off. Second time around for these teams in the group stage. Canada won by 2-1. Lacasse in net on that occasion, making 44 saves, more than twice as many as Rooney had to make at the other end. USA out shooting then the Canadians in that one. But Jocelyn Lamoureux's penalty shot was also one of those big saves by Lacasse. Shot in towards Sabado. So Gosta and Nurse, the scorers for Canada on that occasion, with Coyne responding for USA. It was a fantastic match.
Well, they've had a long history of great matches, these two nations. This is exactly the same.
Fowler's shot. Knight just stretching, couldn't get the rebound. And it's played away by Canada for a line change. 13 and a half minutes to go in this second period, and this game beginning to live up to expectations and falling to the ice now. We have a breakout for Amanda Kessel to try and exploit. Down on the right wing, sweeps behind the goal. Kessel, well, the puck will be lifted away from Kessel, and this is Dayu. Dayu gets it down towards Poulin. One for Poulin to chase, but the good pressure from Poulin there. She gets the puck back from Agosta and scores. Well, Poulin never gave up on what looked like a lost cause in the neutral ice. And great work from Megan Agosta to find her line mate and captain. And at 26:55, Poulin breaks records here, the third time she scored in a gold medal game.
This is as Canadian a goal as you're going to find. Drive it wide, pull the defense with you, drop it back, shoot it, and take advantage of a sliver of space inside this left post. There's a screen in front, and the Canadians have exploited this American defense with some speed, some precise passing, and a quick release by who other than the captain, Marie-Philippe Poulin. The last two gold medal winning goals at the Olympic Games have come off of her stick. They're going to discuss here whether or not there was interference on the keeper. But I don't think there's anything to talk about. It was the American defender in front of goal. So it's just a little bit of tactics there. It's a good goal.
Poulin, who was 3+2 in Sochi, coming alive in the gold medal game. Well, she's 3+3 now, the Montreal player, 26 years old, and captaining the side in her, incredibly, her third Olympic Games. So just after they scored last time around, Canada then went into the penalty box. So they'll look to preserve their discipline a bit more here, as they have, for the first time in this game, a lead. We have 12:26 to go in the first period. Sorry, in the second period. And Poulin on the scoreboard.
Make no mistake of this. This has been monumental from Canada, who were against the ropes. They've now come back in the second period, and they're 2-1 up over USA. And a bouncing puck just getting past the American blue liner, dragging the defense with you. Megan Augusta knows exactly where Poulin is the whole time. There doesn't need to be anything spoken, doesn't need to be a tap of the stick, doesn't even need to be eye contact. Poulin is in right place where she should be on any offensive zone triangle attack. And the depth and the precise movement and the finishing ability there from the Canadians is exceptional.
Well, what can you say about the performances over three gold medal games in three Olympics? Now, record-breaking performances by Poulin, who has scored a goal for Canada in each of the last three Olympic gold medal games. Incredible statistics for a player who is, let's not forget, still just 26 years of age and has got another Olympics or two in her.
Right now, for Rob Stauber, you can see it in his face. He knows that things have just got away a little bit from the Americans in the second period. Schuler, as focused as she was pleading for the call at the end of the first period, remember? I'm not saying that's a part of what's gone on here, but to turn the momentum around as it was against the Canadians, like the Canadians have in the second period, is really something special.
USA moving forward with the Lamoureux sisters in tandem here. Kayla Barnes is the player coming in with the three jersey. The defensive player rushing in on the right-hand side. Never got that far. This is panic across the face of the net. And panic in defence for a moment for Team Canada, as the Lamoureux sisters, who've been impressive in this tournament, starting to cause trouble again. Well, that certainly has brought the noise out of the US fans here at the Gangneung Hockey Centre. The Lamoureux sisters, the line that they formed with Panic, has been very effective in these games. Monique has got a goal and an assist. Jocelyn has got 3+1.
Well, they're outstanding. The Lamoureux sisters, they make hockey happen for USA. They are intentional, they play with purpose, they have intensity at the highest level. And this here, I'm pretty sure that Jocelyn Lamoureux thought she was going to score.
Fortino with the battle behind the goal. It pops out, there's no one there. So over to get involved was Hillary Knight, and Knight still has it. Nice quick backhanded pass to her teammate Brianna Decker. Decker still has it. It's popped out to Knight again. Knight off the post from the tightest of angles. That could have popped out anywhere. And there's another flick in front of the goal. Great save by Zabados as Knight lined one up. Coyne and Decker there creating the traffic, but Zabados was excellent.
Knight is now playing her best hockey of the tournament at just the right time. She's responsible for the American goal. This a shot actually goes off the Canadian defender. Zabados makes the save, but this is the kind of play that Knight has got to bring for the team in blue today.
Been a great response by the American outfit. They are trailing 2-1, but since Poulin's go-ahead goal, USA have come back very strongly, but Agosta comes out to Dayo. Well, there's some space on the... Oh, Welsh. Dayo went to goal there, but steaming in on the right-hand side was the... We had to double-check. It was Jill Saunier, who did not play a single second of ice in the first period, but she was coming in on the right-hand side. Maybe her teammates were as surprised as we were to see her on the ice. Perhaps Dayo then, sorry, it was Fast, who probably could have found the player on the right wing.
Yeah, you could see from the smiles on their face that they're actually quite lighthearted about it, in fairness, that Fast thought, yo, maybe I should have made that play, but I ended up just kind of running out of ideas and I shot it.
Back come USA, flash shot across the face of Zabados' net. It's Pelkey with it, number 37. So we did some checking in between periods to see that if Jill Saunier was injured, she has been relegated off the regular line with her Calgary Inferno teammates, Jenna and Johnson, and didn't have a single second on the ice in the first period, and suddenly burst in from the right-hand side, but never received the pass in the end from Fast. We're into the last 9.5 minutes of the second period. Canada still lead, though, by 2-1. Time of the goal, by the way, 26:55 on Poulin, and some boos there. The fans in this building, not always convinced by the officiating from the European crew, but so far it's been, in spite of the lopsided performance on the power play and the penalties, nothing to remark really about the officiating crew here, predominantly from Europe. And this is Falzer, and this is Knight. Knight inside, Zabados will grab that one, and we have 8:52 to go in the second. 2-1 Canada over USA.
It's fair comment to make about the officiating. There really is no issue with how they've assessed and interpreted this game here so far. For Canada, yes, they're frustrated. They were peeling, looking to maybe get the next call in this game at the end of the first period. But there's nothing really to debate. They have taken the penalties and they have deserved to sit down. And unfortunately, watched from the penalty box, the Americans have taken advantage of it. And now there's Stauber. I'm seeing a lot of communication from Stauber, and I wondered about it earlier in the tournament, whether that style as a man with this women's team, as opposed to Schuler as a former player with her personnel, whether or not that relationship dynamic might just be slightly differential, might be an advantage for Canada.
There's your shots on goal statistics as USA continue to have the lead. But Canada riding a 24-game Olympic winning streak. An absolutely incredible achievement. Can they win an all-important 25th and another gold medal? Morin, chance of USA around the Gang Noon Hockey Center as Johnson gets that one away for Canada. A penalty coming up. It'll be on USA when a USA player gets it. And Saunier back in action again. No time on the ice in the first period, but Saunier wearing the 11 shirt is in the game. And here she comes. Open ice as well. Plays it over. It's a little pass in. And it's back from the knees. Johnson's shot. It was good work from LaRocque, but it is finally a touch from a USA stick. And we'll go to the power play with 8 minutes to go in the second period.
I'll tell you what, as we watch this penalty taken and just stepping in the way of Saunier, that is the American Morin. And then this, they had possession of this puck, Canada, with the delayed penalty coming for best part of 40 seconds. They're looking good right now in Canada. It feels like they're knocking on the door and they're gonna look to steal a third one here.
So let's have a look at the power play for Canada. As we are now in the second half of this middle period, Canada with the power play. And Diou and Fortino lining up on the blue line. This is Fortino into Diou. Poulin over to the right-hand side. The stick goes popping up in the air, high and down back onto the ice. And Johnson lines one up. A block, though, by USA, who have lost a stick. And it was Irwin who went inside the blue of the goalkeeper's crease, and we'll have a whistle on the play.
Considering the Canadians have not been on the power play until now in the second period, they have handled the puck here with wonderful control and imagination. They've created options. As you look at Irwin, has a right foot into blue paint early and quickly called and assessed, but they've been able to take the first look. If it's not there, they go to the B option, they go to the C option, and they did it all under with great poise.
This is Augusta, who's out there with Bridget Laquette and the forward line of Wakefield, Jenner, on this power play. And that one came across to Nurse, the third member of that forward line for the second shift on the power play. 7 minutes to go in the period. Canada with a 2-1 lead, and this is Nurse. Nurse scored against USA last time out. Lays it back. Augusta. Laquette. In front of the net. A shot past the post from Nurse. Misdirected shot in front of the post, getting a tip away as well, I think, as Augusta has it. Augusta gets this one back. Laquette lines up a blasted goal, looking for the skater to the left-hand post as she looked down on Maddie Rooney's goal that wasn't there. Maddie Rooney, just 20 years old, played 3 games in a tournament so far, and that's a waste of some valuable power play time by Canada.
The idea, the quick transition, but it's the puck control. Look at those shirts, 3 of them in this slot area for Canada. Nurse bangs away at it goes wide. And Nurse, she really is, in her first Olympic Games, arriving on the stage. Laquette from the blue line was the player most likely to take the shot. She was working with Augusta with 22 seconds. They'll be pressed to try to get another shot here, the Canadians, but they look good on this player advantage.
Clark with the power play win to Laroque. That's a dash forward by Spooner. Spooner, we haven't seen so much of her in the second period, and it's Coyne on the puck. They're still short-handed for another 5 seconds, but USA with Decker keeping it right round Zabadoza's net. Is Morin is straight back onto the ice and crashing into Laroque straight away. In fact, she rubbed her arm a little bit after that clash. And Laroque plays it down towards Poulin. 5:40 to go in the second period. Irwin and Poulin have scored for Canada to give them a 2-1 lead in this gold medal game. They won the group match by 2-1 as well. You have a feeling, though, that there's plenty more hockey to be played. Then feels like there's more goals left in these sides. Certainly they will be well matched all the way through. No one would have said it's going to be a one-sided affair. We knew it'd be fine margins. We knew it'll be tit for tat. It will be end to end, and that's exactly the way. It's one of the most predictable things in Olympic sport that these two will meet for the gold medal game in the women's ice hockey tournament. That's the way it's panned out. Of course it has. And this is a chance. Wow, we've got another penalty coming up here as the Lamoureux sisters combined again. And to the penalty box will go Melody Diou with the scoreline of Canada 2, USA 1.
You see here at Schuller taking this opportunity again. It's a teaching moment to make sure we remind the personnel on the bench of what the jobs that need to get done here on this penalty kill. Continuing to put themselves under pressure. There, Diou takes the stick right out of the American player. That was Monique Lamoureux. And the Lamoureux sisters, in my mind, as I watch them play, they're the Game Break sisters. If they're going to get back in this game and reassert themselves, the Americans, it looks very much like it's going to come through the Lamoureux sisters. A power play here with 4:47 remaining in this second period. And USA need to grab some offensive mojo again. They need to assert themselves now, just like the Canadians needed to do inside this second period to start. This is America's time.
Team Canada, number 15, Mayo TW. 2 minutes penalty for slashing. 35 minutes, 13 seconds.
Looking to carve out the first chance. Brand took a bit of a hit there on the boards. Dicey moments here for Team Canada.
Yeah, it is. I mean, right from behind there, we lost the puck out of play. Those pucks, of course, are like gold dust. And there, Stauber looks on. He's got the plan already organized with his power play, but oh, it's tough. In and around the boards area as a defender, you simply can't play it like maybe 10 years ago, 5 years ago. You have to be in control of your body. And equally, you have to control the opponent that you hit and how they might fall. This is a discussion going on here. And I'm not sure whether it's because it left the stick directly off of the Canadians. No. What do we got here?
I think it's a discussion on where the face-off should take place.
It did go off the American stick blade and out of play. And that's what had been assessed. So it removes the face-off from the offensive zone and now just outside of Canada's blue line.
Hannah Brand with it for USA, wearing the number 20 shirt. Her sister also playing in these Olympic Games for Korea, who are quite a story in these games. Absolutely fantastic occasions every time the Korean side played. Really a huge part of these games, but of course, it's a gold medal game between USA and Canada once again. And on the power play come USA, carving out a shooting opportunity. It's a decent effort in on Sabados from Kessel. Nurse gets it out of the zone, and it's down the ice by Turnbull. And Canada will take the opportunity to have a full line change of their four skaters as down comes Keller. But Keller, well, Poulin is the player on the puck, and she'll clear that in spite of the best efforts of Kendall Coyne. Here come USA again, 40 seconds to go on this power play for them. 3:25 to go in the second period, and Canada leading by 2-1. Good burst by Coyne, goes back, and Bellamy has it. This is Hillary Knight. Morin is on the right-hand side looking for the shot. Morin back to Bellamy. Bellamy winds but doesn't shoot. Knight does. And it's a block with 3 minutes to go. 13 seconds left on the power play for USA, and Coyne comes in, backhands it to Knight. Knight in front of the net. Zabaros had to be tight to the post there because Knight was sharp in front of the goal. She's got her sharpness back as Knight, and she is in front of the goal looking again to cause trouble. That one pops up for Zabaros as well to make the glove save. No goals on the power play. Both teams back to 5-on-5.
What a crazy sequence there. Fast tries to glove that puck, and she almost knocks in her own goal past Zabados here. As the Americans are in and around the idea of equalizing this game, Hillary Knight, the puck was running through her, as this Kendall Coyne, who we haven't seen a lot of in this game. That looked like he was jammed off of Zabados, maybe inside the post.
That's a high looper, and slightly heart-stopping moment there for Sabados. So it's difficult for netminders because they come few and far between sort of looping shots like that. And with players in front of you, you just have to be super careful. Sometimes, I guess, you don't know whether to go up high to grab it or grab it underneath. But Sabados made the right call on that one. Sabados getting the start. There was chatter beforehand about whether Genevieve Lacasse might play this game. 44 saves for 97.78 in the 2-1 win over USA in the round robin game was absolutely outstanding, including a penalty save. But it was the established Shannon Zabados who, playing her third Olympic Games, a 31-year-old, got the nod in net for Canada. She's conceded just once in the game so far from the tip from Hillary Knight inside. That goal coming at 19:34, but goals in the second period for Irwin and Poulin. As we edge towards the final 2 minutes of the second session, Canada leading by 2-1 now, and they have the puck down on the right-hand side, and there's going to be a penalty. We're going to go to the power play for most of the rest of this period, and it's a call. It looks like it'll be Monique Lamoureux who will go in there for an illegal hit along the boards. And another look at the Canadian power play now.
Well, I spoke about the Lamoureux sisters being game breakers. Is this penalty a game breaker where Canada are going to take advantage of it and increase their margin to 2 goals? Hopefully for Monique Lamoureux Miranda, she is in her heart praying that that is not the case. That an obvious penalty from behind right in front of the Canadian bench, and the Canadians are going to finish this period with control.
This is a huge, huge moment in this gold medal contest. A desperate penalty kill for USA, the advantage to Team Canada. This is Fortino, back to Poulin. Johnson winds up to shoot, but it's blocked straight away. Good block from Megan Keller. Keller has quietly gone about her business in a very effective way. Johnson, though, skates inside this time to create the angle. Past Hannah Brand, and she gets the shot in. Maddie Rooney had to make the save. The penalty kill unit will be changed up for USA, but some good efforts on goal, Rooney having to be sharp.
To the naked eye, it looks very impressive, the puck control here by the Canadians. It's even better than it appears, as they are patient at the right times, they move it at the right times, they're making all the right moves, they're yet to score, but they're in control with this puck.
And that's a important touch away. Very good work down the ice. Well done, Brianna Decker. This is excellent penalty killing by Decker for USA right now.
And they needed it. They needed to respond. It's important to break this Canadian momentum up.
So 50 seconds left on the period, virtually the same amount of time left on the power play. Nurse is out there now for Canada, but that's a Gosta shot. It goes high, but Rooney will make the grab and she'll keep it in her glove. We'll have a face-off with 36 and a half seconds to go in the period. 35 of those seconds will be on the power play. So let's just save the rest of the period, shall we? A little bit easier to do it that way. 2-1. To Canada in a crucial half a minute coming up.
Haley Irwin, it's very obvious now why she has been selected, maneuvered up and down this lineup for Canada, kept as a power play specialist in front. Big body, the goal scorer of the first Canadian goal, but she's equally soft with her touch. She has the right measure at the right times with the touch, and little things are counting right now. As a little clarification over the American bench, everything seems to be in check. We're ready to drop the puck.
Face off, and it's with Canada on the power play. It's Poulin. Poulin looking for the shot back on the blue line, but it's just easing towards Irwin from Fortino, and another whistle on the play. So 25 seconds now left on the power play. Keller getting back onto her skates after the contest along the board with goal scorer Irwin, power play specialist Irwin.
Keller, the tall blue liner, 5'11", 161 is her weight. She's the biggest player on this American side. Other than Lee Steckline, she's right there at 6 feet as well. The two twin towers on the American defensive flanks.
Neutralized face-off, and this is Johnson. Johnson has had an excellent Olympic Games once again, and is out on the power play in the closing seconds of the power play and the period. Canada still with a 2-1 lead, and it's a great clearance down the ice by USA, and that will be that as far as this penalty is concerned. Irwin and Poulin, the two goal scorers, the two last players to touch the puck in that period as well, and we go to intermission with Canada leading by 2-0. Sorry, Canada leading by 2-1 over USA.
Shots on goal in the second period by Team Canada 9.
The same dynamic again at the end of the period. Both teams go to the respective goalkeeper and just encourage them, support them, and equally just help to let them know that, yes, we are doing the right things, as it is the Canadians now off to the dressing room, who were down 1-0 at the end of 20, and they really turned that game around in the second 20.
It was a massive 2-0 period, wasn't it, for Canada, with the goal coming so late for Hillary Knight at the end of the first period on the power play. It was so important for the Canadians to strike back, and they did straight away through Haley Irwin and Poulin, giving them now the 2-1 lead.
It's incredible. At a gold medal caliber game, when everybody knows what's at stake, the pressure, make no mistake, whether the Americans were number one team as far as the International Ice Hockey Federation rankings coming into this tournament, the Canadians still have the pressure as the reigning gold medal champions. So it's all on the Canadians in which to perform. And they were against the ropes with a late goal on the power play, which they had done to themselves. They basically were tying up their own shoelaces in that first period. And look what they did in the second.
Gold medal game, Canada, USA once again, and Canada with a 2-1 lead into the second period. And we have a look there at Kat and Poulin keeping things loose and, well, full of beans as well, the netminder for USA. Zabados with that vital early save. And here is an incredible pick out of the air from Irwin. What a goal that was. Just 2 minutes into the period as well, a vital comeback goal for Team Canada.
Well, it's making your own luck. If you do the right things and you go to that hard with intention, you do create your own luck and you just get the edge and the nod. And it was a totally intentional play by Haley Irwin to get her stick on it, that elevated shot and that pass across, really ultimately what it proved to be.
Zabados sharp on the power play there. Well, shorthanded, the US piled on the pressure. This is a great rush down the ice by Brandt. Again, Zabados making sure these saves stayed out of the net. Maddie Rooney, though, praise for her performance. But here's the goal that she did allow pass. Let's have a look at this one again.
It's just a bang-bang play. It's Augusta and Poulin, who know each other all too well over the course of their Olympic careers and representing the Canadian women's ice hockey program. But that was as clinical and as structured a play by the Canadians, and they finished it. That's the key. It's not a case that they had the chance and they didn't quite get it done. They had the chance and they got it done.
We saw Justin Lambrou with a great opportunity to level it again. Nurse in front as well. Good opportunity for Canada. This is Hillary Knight, who's done really well in front of the net. She's been so busy around there, and it's been really tricky for Canada to ease Knight out of those dangerous positions. So we have 40 minutes play, 20 to go, and if we have a tie game, we'll have another period until they sort it out. The gold medal is up for grabs, and we have a scoreline of Canada 2, USA 1. So here, the Gangneung Hockey Centre, 20 minutes to play in this game, but a 2-0 second period for Canada to take a 2-1 lead. Irwin and Poulin with the vital markers for Team Canada in the second.
It was outstanding. They come out from Blair Turnbull and make that drive down the right wing to start the second period exactly at 2 minutes. I said they needed to respond. I didn't necessarily mean they needed to score in the opening 5 minutes, but they had to bounce back because they got a real sucker punch from the Americans at the end of that first period. The power play, the late deflection inside the last minute. As we look at the second period stats, and how about that? The Americans had 12 shots to 9. Overall in the game right now, it's USA 22 shots to 16 for Canada, but the scoreline favors the Canadians. That's a little bit why it's even got more complexion, this hockey game. You've had both teams with the lead in this game, and the Canadians have had to work by getting two goals in that second period in which to establish that. We've got ourselves an almighty tussle. You also have the Canadians who have made life difficult for themselves with the penalties so far, having to kill it. But both teams, in fairness, are playing very good hockey. It's not as though one of these sides just hadn't shown up today. It is simply a tremendous 20 periods there from Canada to grab a hold of this game again.
So here we go then for what could be the final period of hockey. I say what might be, because should this be a tie game, we'll have an extra sudden death period of ice hockey between Canada and USA here at the Gangneung Hockey Center. Young netminder Matty Rooney leads the team onto the ice. USA shading it in the face-off circle, by the way. 55.56 their advantage, so getting a little bit more puck possession. Marie-Philippe Poulin has now scored in three record-breaking consecutive gold medal games. Incredible stuff from the captain, Hilary Knight, responsible for the goal for Team USA. We tick down towards the start of this third period, and what a game we have on our hands. The gold medal is up for grabs. What lies ahead then in this game, which is turning again into something of a gold medal classic between these two nations? 20 hard years since Olympic gold for Team USA. They have dominated in world championships, although it has to be said, without running you through each and every one of them, some of those gold medal games in the World Championships have been absolutely incredible, going to overtime and again so close. When is it never not close between these two? Johnson forward, Matty Rooney with a big save in the opening stages.
This is a wonderful sweeping skating stride from Rebecca Johnson, who is one of the smoothest skaters in the sport of women's ice hockey. Takes this down the right wing, cuts across, goes east, heading right down the 401. And she gets a shot in on the American keeper. It's in the midsection, but this is good speed and style from the Canadians to start the third.
Kessel backhands it out. Good work. Cameron Azy rushes the net. But nothing there from Hannah Brand to get it towards her teammate. Eventually does now come over, but it's a real battle along the board between these four players. It finally comes out. And it's with the defenseman, Megan Mickelson. Mickelson gets it forward. There'll be a line change for Canada. Huge noise now inside the Gangneung Hockey Center. Irwin is on the ice again. The goal scorer, the important goal scorer, just plucked the puck out of thin air to direct it past Rooney for the comeback goal for Canada. Before Poulin's effort, after great work from her line mates Dio and Augusta, set up the captain for her gold medal goal, her now traditional gold medal goal. Here comes Turnbull for Canada. This is Spooner on the puck, the 24. Natalie Spooner can create a lot of offense using her size and strength for the Canadian side. Laura Fortino and Jocelyn The Rock, the ice time leaders in the game for Canada so far.
Interesting, you talk about Spooner. She doesn't get a lot of time. Is here now, the Americans threaten.
So away by Canada. They have it with Stacy. Stacy and Clark. Clark loops that one into the corners, and the Stacy Clark nurse line will head to the boards and over onto the benches. USA come forward. Offside call there. Looking at the statistics for USA, I mentioned they won marginally in the face-off circle, 55.56%. The Lamoureux have only logged 4 minutes each on the second period. Their ice time lead is, by the way, over 15 minutes for Kendall Coyne, as well as the defensive pair of Keller and Falzer.
And the interesting part about that, I haven't noticed Coyne today like I have in other games, and equally, you notice the Lamoureux when they come out. Spooner, I noticed, but she only had 3:56 in the first period. So it's not always a reflection of the impact by the minutes that you play.
And here comes Coyne now using her pace down the left wing. And the shot was right in on net as well. Zabaros had to be quick down to her glove side to grab that one.
Coyne, she is dynamic. As you say, she's been a little bit quiet in this game, but her speed is her best weapon. And that shot there, particularly in motion, the goalkeeper has to track you and the speed of the puck, and that can be challenging as she makes a good glove save there.
Decker Knight and Coyne on the ice, but it's at the other end, and a shot from Augusta out on her own. Fast provides some support now, and it's back to Augusta after the save is out in front. Dio really should have finished that one. Rooney did well. It was helped by the post, and at the other end is a chance
what
for
a
USA.
Play.
And what a defensive play in front of the net. Absolutely wiping out her opponent, Marie-Philippe Poulin, with the big hit. We have a player down, a stoppage in the play. That was incredible stuff at both ends. Decker is down hurt.
But the poke check from Zabados, as we watch, I think Decker's just lost her win. There was a massive collision here. What happens is Zabados realizes that her defense has been breached as Brianna Decker looks to be okay. Stauber right up to the bench now wants some clarity about what just went on that sequence. Hillary Knight had beaten the Canadian defenseman and had moved the puck over, and I believe it's to Decker. As Poulin's coming back, Knight lofts it over. It is to Decker. Poulin levels her. And that's the challenge here. But look at the poke check by Zabados.
Fantastic.
Oh, my goodness. That is massive. We do have a little bit of an issue here now as to how this is going to lay out. As that from Hillary Knight was enough, Poulin shows no mercy. And she catches the Amtrak heading straight into Boston.
Still some discussion as Coach Stauber has the non-decision explained to him, because it seems it will stay 5-on-5 and Poulin has skated back to the bench after the big hit. But you're right, Zabados, a game saver there.
Oh, it's an incredible poke check. I'll be honest, I don't know how Poulin gets away with not being penalized there. That's incidental contact. Poulin had nowhere else to go, in fairness, but she had committed to the defensive play, and then no one could go anywhere. Unfortunately, Decker went down.
Here come Canada. It's a useful breakout this, and it's a shot past the post from Mickelson. Well, suddenly, around Rooney's goal, we got a big breakout by the Canadian unit. Johnson tries to get it in front. It's out in front now. Oh! Saulnier just couldn't quite get it onto her backhand for the final effort. So Saulnier now back on this line with Jenna and Johnson, reunited with her line mates in the third period. Curious line making decision making from the Canadian bench, but they are leading this game by 2-1. Wouldn't dare second guess them, but Saulnier will be desperate to get more involved in this game. No time in the first minute. A couple in the second, in the first period, sorry, no time. A couple of minutes in the second. Saulnier back re-establishing her partnership on that Calgary Inferno line for Team Canada. Irwin is out there again. The power play specialist has been giving regular shifts in this game. And the scoreboard with 15 and a half minutes to go still reads Canada 2, USA 1. Steckline brings it back to get the shot off. Turnbull was right in front of her, parks there to make sure there was no clean shot on goal. It's just a good tip away there by Turnbull. So USA will have to regroup. But it's really important for USA just to keep this momentum going. They've had a couple of good chances already in this final period.
They need to engage this crowd. That's a part of an attribute. It's an asset. It's an advantage for the Americans. They have to play with energy, they've got to play with speed. The Canadian defense is right on right now.
Oh, what a move that was. Very close to getting in there was Gigi Marvin. It's still there for USA, though. Great battle by the USA team. But finally coming in to play it out of defense were Canada. And Stacey will chase that all the way down to Rooney's net. A little bit of pushing at the end there between Stacey and Kayla Barnes. One of the youngsters in this team, Laura Stacey. Decker is back on the ice. It's good to see Decker back on the ice after that heavy hit.
Exactly. That collision there as we watch just the play coming in and almost there with Jill Saunier, a chance to take the backhand. But that play on Decker, fortunate that there wasn't a contact on the head. It was more taking the air out of her chest, no doubt. The impact, it was stunning. It was just too much velocity without her having to go down. And it's great to see that she's back and ready to play.
Rooney had to save from Agosta there, as Agosta got another shot off. Canada's 20th shot of the game so far against USA's 23. It was a huge shot count in favor of USA in the group match, but Canada won that one by 2-1. That's where the scoreline stays at the moment. What will happen in the remaining 13 and something minutes of this gold medal game? You have to remember that 4 years ago, USA took a 2-0 lead into the final 7.5 minutes before Canada came back with two stunning goals to force overtime, sudden death overtime, which Canada won to take gold medal. So drama surely ahead in this one. Cameron Azey for USA just let that one go too far ahead, and again, so steady. When Mickelson is on the puck, it just seems to, the world just seems to slow down a little bit. And Mickelson seems to have an extra time to get it away, and she did so again. This is Monique Lamoureux. A giveaway there, though, by Lamoureux. Mickelson has it, backhands it into the zone, but Turnbull was offside, so there'll be a whistle on the play. 12:51 to go.
When you talk about Mickelson and how everything slows down, as we are reminded, confirmation of the score in the gold medal game. It's Canada 2-1 over USA.
At 33, the oldest player in the Canadian team from the Calgary Inferno. No goals but one assist for Mickelson, but it's her defensive work which is really so strong.
As a unit and as an entire squad of players, Canada, from the forwards all the way back, or from the goalkeeper all the way up front, they all commit to playing the team game and defense. Nobody is looking to try and steal a goal here by hanging long and looking for long service. They are all committed to their individual responsibilities, and the lines and how they've been constructed are put together by coach Laura Schuler in which to enhance each other's attributes and characteristics to create balance. Some lines will have, of course, more offensive potency, others more defensively minded, but all the Canadian players skate, and they have been tracking the Americans in this third period so far, and they're in pretty good shape, although it's only a one-shot difference.
Back underway with USA on the attack. That's a big blast across the face of the net. Good effort in from Jocelyn Lamoureux, but Zabados has had a very, very good game in net for Canada, facing there her 24th shot. This one coming from 17, Jocelyn Lamoureux, looking for her fourth of the tournament.
And it's dangerous because it comes off the Canadian defensewoman's stick, and that can go anywhere, the late redirection.
It's out in front from Megan Duggan's hustle. It's still in there and it's jabbing away at it. It was Duggan and Gigi Marvin there thrashing away at the loose puck, and it's not to be. We'll have a face-off from the restart.
This is what the Americans have to do. They simply cannot take no for an answer. They have to be persistent. They have to keep knocking on the door And eventually, hopefully, they are able to beat Zabidas to level this game at two.
It was Duggan and Marvin who are out there in their third Olympic Games. It all seemed like an odd day indeed when you're not naming those players in the lineup. The youngsters coming through, though, like this one, number seven, Stacy for Canada, with that shot passed. And this is nice smooth skating from Canada as Fortino gets a shot off. It's past the post. Stacy was in there. Fortino and Rougeau were the two players looking to line up shots on that one. The youngster Clark battles really well. What good work by Clark. Oh, and neutralized. Just crept up on her opponent, robbed the puck, and turned and slid it down the ice to set up another offensive opportunity for Canada. They still lead 2-1. Here's Kendall Coyne. Kendall Coyne, so big in this tournament for USA, the number 26. She's played a really good tournament out here in Pyeongchang 2018. But it's been a magnificent women's competition. There's been some magic moments for Japan and for Korea, for Switzerland, Finland and the OAR. But nothing more magic than a gold medal game between these two sides. Always fantastic when they meet. It's Canada, USA into the final portion of this classic gold medal matchup. Canada with their noses in front still, having to defend as the big chance of USA go up from the crowd at the Gangneung Hockey Center. A giveaway, a chance, is Irwin. She hasn't quite got the legs to get forward to create the chance, but it was a breakdown by USA as they try and regather, regroup and get forward again. Camoranesi has it. Camoranesi shoots. Zabidas with a big rebound. It's in front of the net. It's turned in by Brand, but Zabidas is unbeaten. There's another chance in front of the goal. It's a block. This time it goes back. It pops back to Brand. Brand tries to get it inside. The little tip wasn't quite there for USA, and Canada survived that one. Wow.
It's a sequence there. The Canadians are having to hold on. It's a little bit like the rainy season, and you want to batten down the hatches. And the weather is coming from the Americans as they blow in here with some of the best intention of this game and equally this third period. The movement across the line is sharp. The shot in, the first one, the second. It's this one here as Kessel makes that play in the coin. And then the defense dropped down as well. But you've got all of the Canadians in front, and they're like defensive octopuses. They've got sticks, arms, legs everywhere, and they're able to break down the shots equally coming in from the Americans.
Rougeau, Mickelson, Poulin, Diou, Agosta, the big guns out there for Canada. As they'll say, hey, look, let's settle down, everybody. We're still winning this one by 2-1. No need to panic just yet. Let's just try and stop that sort of thing happening again, the big activity around Zabidas' net. Let's bring it forward, let's win this shift and take it from there. Less than 10 minutes to go in this game. Nurse Clark and Stacy now out there for Canada, and well, we both look to the referees for a decision there. It didn't come. We are 5-on-5. No power play forthcoming, and Lamoureux has it. Lining up the shot. Oh, it's a loose one for number 17, Jocelyn Lamoureux, in front of the net at the other end of the ice. Here comes Stacy. Nurse chases that one back. We got young legs on the ice playing this long shift for Canada. Stacy, though, will wrap that one around the boards and there'll be a line change.
It's becoming clear in women's ice hockey there. Oh, it's a good play by the Canadians that they allow more and more physicality. That will be the case in the remaining 9 minutes of this game.
Here come USA pushing through Pelkey, but it's going to be an offside call. Pelkey picked it up the wrong side of the blue line, and we have 9 minutes remaining and a scoreline of Canada 2, USA 1.
These two nations bring the best out of each other. They play their best hockey when they play one another, and that really makes sense. Generally, as an athlete, of course, you want to go out and perform to your best. The opponent's doing their best to counteract you, and that's what, of course, is going on here in this game. But the energy and equally the challenge, that rivalry, that peer rivalry between these two nations, elevates these two teams up, and it's the Americans that need a little bit more from Kendall Coyne. Some of their depth, the Lamoureux sisters are there. They need a little bit more from Hillary Knight right now. Up front, they need a little more from Amanda Kessel. Those are players that the Americans count on, and if you want to win a gold medal, you got to play your best game in the gold medal game.
Decker, Knight and Coyne out on this forward line. Bellamy just behind them with Kayla Barnes as USA trying to grab the goal that would bring them back into this gold medal contest. Coyne, big bounce. Bellamy is there to pick it up. Bellamy has been absolutely fantastic in this tournament. Possible all-star in this Olympic Games. There will be five players and one netminder named to an all-star team. Of course, a fictional all-star team, but a bit of fun and a nice reward for those six players at the end of this tournament. It's been a great tournament, and so far the gold medal game is not disappointed. It's a giveaway, it is a chance for USA to get forward. A big whoa goes up from the crowd, but there was nothing really there for Decker, and Canada have it, albeit behind their own goal at the moment. And this is Laura Fortino quietly again going about her business and logging so many minutes on the ice. Agosta brings that one forward. Whistle on the play, just under 8 minutes to go. I still feel there's another twist and turn to this one somewhere.
Well, that's fair. That's fair to think that. And history has proven that. You talk about Fortino, she is a pure defenseman on both sides of the puck. The way she manages the game, this is what's going on from Canada right now. Their game management is the best in the world. They're managing the last 5 minutes of play and the remaining under 8 minutes. That's what they'll have to do best right now against the Americans to claim gold.
This team from Canada has been together since August 2017. It's a very similar program to the one run by the US. Both these squads running a centralized system where they play together as the Olympic team in most of the year building up to it. By the way, they've met each other in the build-up to this tournament 8 times in various competitions. Canada with a 5-3 lead over those 8 games. And most of them, as you can imagine, have been razor-sharp close, as we have nearly 7 minutes to go in the game, just over 7 minutes to go in the game, and here comes Lamoureux, plays that one back. Bellamy's high shot grabbed by Sabadoff, and the Canadian fans love that shot, and they love that shot stop from Sabadoff.
Renata Fast here shows you how to go about playing defense here in a gold medal game to help your nation win. She stays with Lamoureux right to the end boards. Not a moment of daylight does she give Lamoureux on the backhand to try to get a shot in on Zabados and create chaos in front of the Canadian goal.
What a great addition she's been to the defensive lineup for Team Canada. Plays in Toronto. The 23-year-old Fast, surely not her final Olympic Games. She's done so well out here in Korea during this tournament. But you don't want to talk up anybody too much, because it's just one little individual moment that could break this game out one way or the other. And here comes the youngster, Stacey. Stacey has Nurse with her. Stacey goes it alone and shoots past the post. Oh, wide open space for Lamoureux. Lamoureux scores! Monique Lamoureux has tied it up with 6:21 to go. How did she find that open ice? Incredible scenes. USA back into this one. 6:21 to go. It's all tied up at 2-2, and Lamoureux scores.
Oh, my. As from one end, a chance to break this game. And a save is made by Maddie Rooney. And then Lamoureux, the experience and the finish here. Right past Zabados. How does she get alone? Nobody knows. But she scores, and that's all that matters now. We're level at 2.
Wow. What a passage of play that was. Just over 6 minutes to go. Well, when do we start using... Oh. Poulin very nearly got the coughed up puck there, but Pelkey and Steckline between them getting it away. When do we start using the word overtime? Or is that two words hyphenated? Overtime pending if we can't break this 2-2 scoreline. We'll have a full break, a full ice cut. But let's not talk about that now, because here comes Augusta. There's still a lot of hockey to be played in regulation time of this tie game. The time of the goal, 53:39. Kelly Panik also getting a notification on that one. The assist from Panik. Lamoureux, Monique Lamoureux, number 7, in wide open space, and made no mistake once given that chance.
It was a poor line change by the Canadians, and a wholesale poor line change. And maybe they thought shot at one end was going to stay on the target. They miss, and off the breakout for the Americans.
The USA have a jump in their skates right now. That was Kendall Coyne working hard. Kessel is out on the ice now. We're with Kessel on the puck, and inside is in front of the net, and such a chance. It's still bobbling around there. Well, Kessel was in there and suddenly had open ice in front of her to feed her line mate. Here was another close call for Canada, who've got to be careful. I think maybe they will be the team that would be happiest to see this one go to overtime right now, because USA pushing and out shooting their opponent 29-22 over the game so far, with 4:20 to go, and the crowd are certainly into this one. Huge chance of USA. You can never count out Canada. It was a late goal from Canada, as we have a power play going on Team USA. A late goal that equalized for Canada back 4 years ago before they won in overtime. But what will we see here? We're going to the power play with USA. There's 4:11 to go, and Canada and the United States of America are tied at 2-2.
We see the look in the eye again, the Canadian coach, Laura Schuler, as Emily Clark has gone to the penalty box with 4:11 remaining in the third period. It could be the game if something dramatic happens here for USA. It's an offensive zone penalty. It's a penalty. And you just simply can't take a penalty in the offensive zone now. Here it is. The play, the game leveling goal. Lamoureux. Oh my. The sheet taker moment. Right under the arm of Zabados.
To go. One goal on 5 power plays so far for USA. They have the extra skater now. We're in the third period of this game. Emily Clark, the youngest member of the squad, goes off the ice. There's the big shot from Bellamy, the first effort on goal in this power play. Bellamy, that's one slip, and it's a breakout chance for Augusta. Augusta's on her own. She'll go for goal here. Wasn't able to get much on it. Surrounded by blue shirts, Maddie Rooney makes the blocker save quite comfortably. Here comes Kendall Coyne, resetting things very quickly. Good burst of pace by Coyne. She's got Decker behind her, but she goes instead to Hillary Knight. This is Knight back to Decker. Steckline is on the blue line looking for the shot with Morin. Morin's blast, glove save by Zabados.
We're moving into territory here with 3:23 to go, where it's effectively like overtime right now. Barnes with this shot. Another goal in this game. Who knows? It could be the finisher. It could just be the igniter for the opposition, in which to try to level it right back again.
Yes, Barnes with the big blast from the right-hand side here. She is again the number 3. Little trickler in front of Zabados' net. She plays safety first. She'll cover that one. We'll have another face-off. 3:08 to go. 58 seconds left on this power play. These next 58 seconds could well decide the destination, whether immediately or in the long run, of the gold medal out here in Pyeongchang. Steckline. Again, over to Kayla Barnes. Lamoureux looking for a blast, but goes back to Barnes. Barnes has another go at it, but it's beaten away straight away by Canada's Brianna Jenner. ...30 seconds left on the power play. They don't want to waste any shots here. They're looking for the right one. USA coming inside. Oh! The Lamoureux sisters combining there. This is Jocelyn. A little touch by Jenner, but it's kept in well by Barnes, who's logged a lot of time on this power play. Over to Steckline, they've changed sides. And huge relief, huge cheers from the Canadian contingent as Canada return to full strength, and Clark straight into the action for Johnson, who sweeps that one in, and the penalty is killed by Canada. The chance goes away for USA. We're into the final 2 minutes of regulation time in this tied gold medal game. Poulin for Canada.
It was an effective penalty kill, just what they needed.
Agosta.
They were strong and smart, but the Canadians, they'll try to assert themselves in these remaining portions.
Agosta there, just for a moment, trying to cough that puck back in front for Dayu or Poulin. Poulin has it now. Twists and turns. 1:25 to go. Big shot through traffic, but it's blocked in the first instance. Cameron Azey, the sharpshooter, blocked that one. And here come USA. Oh, it's a move in front of the goal. It's a flash shot across the net of Zabados. Well, thrilling stuff as we approach the final minute of this game, and it's still not away for Canada. Now they have a chance to break out with Jocelyn Larocque to Dayu, and some of these players need to get off the ice. There's some tired legs, especially on the Canadian unit, as Nurse and Clark and Stacey, the youngsters, come out to see this game through possibly the last 44 seconds. But USA have it. Big pressure from the US team. That's gone outside the zone. That was careless work from USA, because they snuck on the extra skater. Into the action came Emily Fowler, but she was behind the blue line when she took the puck, so an offside call. A shame, because USA were pushing forward there.
Well, it's a big let-off for the Canadians, and maybe a little disappointment for the Americans. I think, in fairness, though, both of these sides would be happy to go into overtime here. We would have a 20-minute overtime. We'd have a 15-minute intermission, 35 and a half seconds to determine whether or not we require it.
Into the final half minute of regulation 60 minutes ice hockey in this women's gold medal game. What a game it's been. It has not for a single second disappointed. We knew it was going to be close. We hoped it was going to be a classic. I think we've been fulfilled on both ambitions. And here they come again. Canada with a chance. Nice little move there from Jenner, but just couldn't quite get the final shot. We'll tick this down. I don't think they'll have another chance as Saunier hits the ice. In fact, it's popped out of the zone, so we'll have no further scoring opportunity unless there's a big shot from deep here. There is, but there's nothing on that one. There goes the buzzer. Wow. We are unbreakable. We have a 2-2 scoreline. We have played 60 minutes. It's time to catch your breath, everybody. The tying goal came late. It came for the USA. We are going to sudden death overtime with a scoreline of Canada 2, USA 2. So the teams leave the ice because we are going to overtime, and because it's a gold medal game, there's no just quick, any quick tidy up of the ice and going straight back to it. They will take a whole break here. We'll go to a whole 20 minutes of overtime, so they'll take a period break here. They'll have a full ice cut, and then we'll restart with sudden death overtime at 20 minutes.
It needs it, considering what's at stake. The ice was getting heavy. You could see the snow building up in front of the bench areas, certainly in the high traffic areas, in the crease. in and around the nets, and you saw how hard the work that was going in from the players. There was fatigue very evident there at the end of the third period from both sides. It's the emotional tax as much as it is the physical energy that is expended in a game like this. Whoa, overtime is what's in store. It's going to be 20 minutes. I don't think we're going to go that deep.
I mean, who knows? I mean, if you scripted the last 20 years of this rivalry, people would throw your book in the trash saying it's too fictional. Yeah, but it's incredible the matches between these sides. And yet again, we've got another one for the ages here. It's tied at 2-2. We're going to sudden death to decide who gets the gold medal after 60 minutes couldn't separate these two fantastic teams. Well, thank goodness there is a nice 15-minute break here, because I think everybody in the building needs it. Here are some of the many highlights of that, and Coyne getting forward. Zabados was looking so solid to come up with some really good grabs early in this. And Matty Rooney not doing too badly at the other end either.
Well, the save she makes here, that's by Daou coming right down. She's got to track it. Hillary Knight, this is the play here that was a turning point. I don't know. Brianna Decker was taken out hard by Marie-Philippe Poulin. I don't know how Poulin didn't get a penalty. You're saying that she's competing for the puck. Decker maybe holding her space. That was chaos, but what a poke check from Zabados too. She uses it like she's putting coal in the oven. And she comes out to make sure. And this now, so many chances, so many partial opportunities where the puck just kind of maybe flips at the wrong time. There's a good save from Zabados. And we're going to see
more saves from Zabados. She was really, really hot in this period.
32 total shots that we have in the game so far for the Americans. And they had a heavy advantage. This is one end all the way down. Stacy shoots, and then how quickly the play turns back up. Right through the legs. They get fortunate. They create their own luck, and they finish it. They have to have game breakers. Lamoureux, well, both of them are capable of doing that for the United States of America, as you see the finish here from Monique Lamoureux Morando. And that's a big one.
Great vision from Kelly Panett to find her teammate. 53-39 on the clock. And after that, the teams both went at it looking for the game winner, which wasn't to come. And we have a scoreline at the end of the game of Canada 2, USA 2, we're going to overtime. The Gangneung Hockey Center has seen yet another classic game between these sides. Whenever they meet, it's great. When they meet for gold medal, it's the absolute pinnacle. And it's tied after, yet again, we're going to go to overtime in a gold medal game between Canada and USA. USA pulling it back to 2-2, 13-39 to Lamoureux in that final period of regulation. Wow, it's incredible stuff though, wasn't it?
It certainly was. It's living up to its billing as this reflection of the game stats so far. 32 shots. They've come roaring forward, the Americans, in the third period of play. Just a marginal advantage. They've had so much more time in the power play than the Canadians in this game. But one of the things we've been chatting about here as we prepare for this overtime period is that, not wanting to be controversial, but Marie-Philippe Poulin is lucky to still be in this hockey game, as she was involved in a collision in front of her own goal defending that woman right there. Now, Zabados made the poke check. We cannot go back and rewind the clock, but what a collision. We didn't give it probably as much due as was required at the time, but now upon hindsight, if you look back, Poulin is the lady for Canada, the captain, who has scored the last two game-winning goals in the game, in the gold medal game against the United States, is still in this hockey game. And you could very much argue that she just unfortunately crossed the line in that collision, and possibly at least could have been penalized. But that's water under the bridge, as Canada will return to the ice first. The ice is clean. It's been resurfaced. It's also had a new sheet of water that's frozen. And she's as good as you want it to be to maximize this moment in the goal game.
...30 seconds until the restart. It is overtime. It is sudden death. The next goal will be the golden goal. Incredible comeback from USA with Lamoureux's goal in the final period. Exchanges at both ends after that. We are moments away from the restart. Sudden death overtime. Canada and USA tied at 2-2.
Stauber adjusts the tie. It's as good a time as any.
Keller forward to Coin. We're into overtime of this tie game. 60 minutes couldn't separate Canada or USA. Keller winds up the first shot of the sudden death overtime period, and it's away by Zabadov. Coin back in front just for a moment there. Decker skating in, but here comes Augusta. Augusta with Poulin. Poulin, the gold medal specialist. She's done it before. She's won the game for the last two Olympic finals with the game-winning goal in tight games. Could Poulin do it an incredible third time? We have 4-on-4 on the ice. There will almost certainly be a breakthrough. There is going to be so much open ice. 4-on-4 on the big Olympic ice. We played a minute of sudden death. And here comes Rebecca Johnson. Bellamy holding her off, but Jenner comes forward. Jenner sees that one bobbing in front of the net. Bellamy and then Barnes tidy things up for Tino. Back to Johnson. Johnson in front. And that's what happens when you've got four skaters. The open ice can go both ways, can't it? And it meant there was no one there to grab hold, no center to pick up the pass from behind the net from Johnson as Daou is teamed up out there. We're looking at the combinations of these teams as they have Spooner and Daou out together for Canada. But at the other end, it's the USA coming forward. That shot was from Callie Flanagan. Flanagan wearing the six for USA. Not seen much of her in this game, but she's getting 4-on-4 time out there with Hillary Knight.
They're different passing lanes when you're playing 4-on-4, obviously, than 5-on-5, so you got to get your head up, you got to move your feet, and if you don't have the first pass available to you, you've got to be willing to come back on yourself, but you've got to keep moving your feet the whole time.
Steckline to Keller. Out on the ice, there's a chance in front, it's gone past the post, though. The blast was from Kelly Panic, and down the other end comes Augusta. Augusta shoots, it takes a deflection off Bowser into the netting behind the goal, and we'll have a stoppage with 17:33 to go in overtime. Canada with a chance to get things going, well, not get things going, but to win the whole game.
Well, yes, here as they battle, this is Rebecca Johnson, and why not take a crack at it? It doesn't have to be pretty to be historic, as this one goes wide equally for the Americans.
Poulin and Augusta out there with Decker and Coin, the opposite forwards. Well, a little bit too long, Decker, to try and get the puck out there. Poulin was right on it, and they're digging away through Bowser. Decker comes away with it, but a turnover and a dangerous one there. Whoa, Johnson was in very quick on that one. Keller. Johnson so lively in the sudden death overtime period. We find ourselves down to this. The next goal will win the gold medal We have four skaters against four for the entire duration of this to create the scoring opportunities. And Camoranesi lays it off. Camoranesi gets it back. Oh, tips it. Hayley Irwin style, but it's not into the back of the net. And Canada come forward through Jenna. But what work from Camoranesi, the sharp shooting number 24. She's had a great game. And she's on the puck again there with a fast pass, past Nurse. And it's shot down behind the goal. Zabados will dub that one out. But a great chance for USA. Wow. Close call.
It could have been it, without a doubt. Any of these shots can be there. Camoranesi with a hot hand for USA. Takes her chances. As now with some speed, they'll come forward.
Steckline. Plays that one over to Flanagan. Flanagan, obviously a key part of this four-on-four strategy for USA. Flanagan rushes to the bench. The line changes are also completely different, of course, when you have only four skaters on the ice. There's lots of stuff for the players on the ice to get used to in this overtime period, but a chance for USA. Lines up the shot, Lamoureux with it. Just a little bit behind was Kelly Panik. Lamoureux went her own way.
This had some pepper on it, make no mistake, as she toe drags it in to her feet area. She elevates it as we look at Danny Camoranesi with the opportunity a few moments ago as she breaks the play up and then goes to the net hard. And this touch, I think if it's on inside the post, she's got a chance to be a gold medal hero. It just goes wide by a foot and a half.
Still great work there, wasn't it, by Camoranesi, and she did so well to get that in on goal, just slightly past the post. Super effort though, and here we come with Jenna, but Jenna is robbed, and back comes Coyne. Coyne has three Canadians in front of her. Just bides her time, doesn't use her speed on this occasion, just bides her time, waits for some support from the blue shirts of Team USA. And Bellamy with a mistake there, and it very nearly allowed Johnson in, but there was no one there with Johnson on this occasion. Diou comes on, and the line changes haven't quite connected so far for both sides. They're getting used to this four-on-four. No breakthrough yet, no gold won yet. We're into the sudden death stage of this fantastic competition, and this is Diou Spooner using her size and strength. She is such a creative player, the number 24 for Canada. Flanagan getting a lot of time on the four-on-four with Hillary Knight as her offensive partner. Keller wants it, but Knight has it. Battle there between Knight and Spooner, won by Spooner. Two of the more strength-laden players in this contest. 14 minutes of sudden death. If they can't sort it out here, and I can't for a minute think with this open ice and four-on-four, we won't get a goal, we'd go to a penalty shootout.
It used to be that four against four in with 10 minutes of additional time always proved a result. And over the last 3 to 5 years, the skating ability, the defensive structure, the shot blocking, and just the game's evolution, it's becoming more and more difficult to determine, especially when you have the two world's best. And a little bit of controversy on the icing. Of course, you can't remove the players. They've got to stay on the ice. The four players that were on when the play was down, Canada tried to be a little clever and get Poulin out there.
Larocque remains out on the ice. As does Fortino. For Canada. And Keller tries to keep it in, can't do so. It slips out of the zone. Monique Lamoureux. This is Fowler. Fowler forward, Lamoureux lurking behind the goal. And so far, it's been a cagey spell with not too many chances on this overtime period. Strange that some ways the heat has gone out of the game a little bit. Both teams so desperate not to make a mistake, which would cost them a gold medal. But now here's a chance. Down the ice comes Bellamy, swings it down to her right-hand side in coin. Here come Canada with the defensive play, trying to get it out, but no, it's still in the possession of coin. But here it pops out to Agosta. Agosta on her own again. Not for the first time, Agosta finds herself just out on her own and no way forward for Megan Agosta. Bellamy has it for USA. 7 minutes of 4-on-4 sudden death overtime played already. Bellamy for USA. Bellamy shoots it round the board. Picked up by Kendall Coyne, but here come Canada. Now this is a bit more like it. They've got a good break on here with Rebecca Johnson to Fortino. Fortino makes a shot and Rooney makes a save. Johnson though straight on there, gets it back to Fortino. Johnson still fighting for it. Cameron Azey just getting it to Steckline, and Bellamy has it for USA. Bellamy needs a break and she goes to the boards, and this is Cameron Azey. Cameron Azey tries to make a way in front of the net, but there's no returning pass there from her number 20, Hannah Brandt. And here comes Nurse. Well, now we're starting to get some end-to-end action as USA come forward. 12 minutes still to go in sudden death, unless there's a goal which will finish it. 60 minutes, couldn't separate the sides as Knight and Irwin exchange goals. Poulin gave Canada the lead. And then Monique Lamoureux levelling at 53-39. It was a fantastic 60 minutes. We are now into sudden death overtime. There'll be a whistle on the play. And how do you call this one so far? I mean, pretty even Stevens, right?
It has. It's been very disciplined. In this women's ice hockey gold medal game, we're at overtime. Dead level of two, USA and Canada. They've played each other so much, though, in recent months, and understand each other equally in their styles of play, that the discipline that they're employing and how they measure up against each other, it does bring about this leveling off period here, even though we've got the extra space on the ice and we have the urgency of a next shot and a score being a gold medal victory.
Fast was the player looking for Poulin. Keller was back there quickly, though, for USA. Keller and Bellamy have been used a lot on the 4-on-4 in defense so far for the team in blue. Here come Canada and Rebecca Johnson again looking lively. Not finding much support out there. This is where the skill can really come into play. Mickelson joining the play, but a little bit too late. There's a breakout chance for USA. Megan Duggan. And plenty of turnovers in neutral ice. This is Megan Mickelson again, just calming things down, the number 12. What an influence she's on the ice. She has the puck now, does Mickelson, and she's got Spooner, another veteran campaigner, with her. Goes forward instead to Wakefield, and that's gone all the way down to the corners, and USA will gather that one. Here's Bellamy.
Very thoughtful play from Mickelson, the way she advanced that. It didn't get connected to a Canadian stick, as here comes Lamoureux. She's the hot rocket and the pocket rocket for this American side.
Jocelyn Lamoureux on the puck, 17. Goes to ground, falls to ice. Here come Canada. Inside comes Fortino. A little bit too much on that for Spooner, but Spooner takes the puck back off the boards and wheels round for a shot. Rooney blocks that one and it falls, much to her relief, to Callie Flanagan out of Boston College, a 22-year-old Flanagan, getting a lot of 4-on-4 time for USA. Steckline. Decker swings that in front of the net, but this will be away from Jocelyn Leroux. Agosta tidies it up. Poulin down the ice.
Again, it's just smart. They make line changes. They make sure they've got fresh personnel out there. Over halfway gone in this 20-minute overtime period. It is unprecedented if we weren't to get a result here in live play. But right now, everyone is doing their job.
Coyne, it falls to Keller. Keller never got her shot off there, but the effort on goal from Coyne was good, and Zabados had to be sharp there. And here comes Jenna for Canada. Jenna still on the backhand, gets it into the near post. Rooney there, doesn't pop out for Johnson. Jenner and Johnson team together. Brandt loses that one out. What a great piece of work. And it's a chance for Clark. Clark falls to the ice after the excellent check from Nurse. But back the other way with Camoranesi. Camoranesi is up high. Zabadov will make the grab. A long time until the whistle came. It did. And with 8:36 to go in sudden death, Canada and USA still 2-2.
Even that save made there by Zabadov over your head. Of course, for a moment, as you glove that puck, you just are partially not following right through the glove because it's so high. This was the chance. Turned over. Emily Clark just kind of loses her balance here in the end, and she gets pumped off the play. It's great defensive work there from Bellamy to front up against her. Both sides, every player who's been given an opportunity to be on the ice so far is exactly doing what their coaches want.
From the faceoff, then, 8.5 minutes to see if we can separate these sides without going to a penalty shootout. What drama we have in this game. It's sudden death. Zabadov makes another save, this time from the quick release. Hillary Knight with a shot from the right-hand faceoff circle.
And even more so in overtime, the shots coming in, regardless of whether or not they're A quality, you've got to take them because not every overtime winner has been beautiful. As Hillary Knight has one of the strongest shots in the women's game, you've got to take them because if you don't, at the times when they're available, you might never get a chance again.
Here comes Johnson for Canada. Still has plenty left in the tank, does Johnson. It's good work from number six, getting down the boards, but Stekline plays that one away, and there's a chance for a breakout for USA. It's good work. Kessel inside. This is Knight. Knight with a big shot. Knight has been in such trouble around the net, in front of the net. With the extra open ice there, we're seeing the best of Knight, the shooter. Kelly Panic. Panic cuts back inside, looks for her line mate Monique Lamoureux. Stekline. This is to Panic again. In fact, she'll leave it, and it's with Casey Bellamy. Bellamy gets all the way forward on this rush. And there's a hit on Panic along the boards in the corner, but it's a chance in front. Again, a close call as Kenny Panic out of the University of Minnesota tried to score her first goal of the tournament. Here come Canada on the attack now. It's Rougeau who will just play that one in. They'll take the chance to get the line change, but Bellamy is still out there. Some tired legs from the number 22. Surely she's played a very long shift on 4-on-4. She'll now make herself available for change. And here's Poulin. Poulin, this is LaRocque behind the goal. Looking for Diou, but Keller will get it away. We have less than 7 minutes to go in the sudden death, but it's wide open as a chance. All of a sudden, Megan Keller getting forward. Close call to breaking this sudden death overtime period. USA so close to a gold. They've been denied gold since Nagano. It's been a painful Olympic progress since then for USA as Canada have owned the gold medal. They brought a 24-game winning streak into this one here at the Olympic Games. It's Decker. USA still coming forward, less than 6 minutes to go. Stekline can't line up the shot back from the blue line, but this is good puck possession from USA.
An important break up there for the Canadians who are getting tired back there, but they are staying with it as every one of the athletes are. This is now getting crucial to keep your focus.
Long pass forward there was for Jenner, and Jenner comes back and grabs it for herself after the clearance. Mickelson on the puck, just looking around, assessing her options. She goes up through the middle to Johnson. Johnson creates herself a little bit of time and uses a bit of a move, but it's taken off of Johnson just in front of the US bench. As we have around 5 minutes to go now in sudden death.
And just an offside play there, just losing their footing, and then the advancement across the line brings about the whistle as over the boards again. We are seeing so much great work there for Megan Keller, but this an opportunity right down Broadway. And yes, Zavdos does get an arm to it. That could have been the difference from Keller coming off the blue line. There's just enough room there to get a good scoring chance in.
Well, it's just so tense inside the Gangneung Hockey Center as Canada come forward and the Rock plays it out of defense. Poulin, can she be the game winner once again for Canada? It would be incredible stuff were she to, for the third time, score a gold medal winning goal. Remember, it went to overtime in Sochi before Poulin broke the deadlock 4 years ago in favor of Canada. Nice burst forward here, and the puck will still stay with America. It was a good skate up the ice from Jocelyn Lamoureux to create that. This one will just pop out of the zone, so US will have to build from the back. It's been a fantastic contest between these two rivals. Panic still has it, leaves it for a teammate, and inside, that effort too far off. And that's a great shot, well saved by Zavdos.
Canadian legs are getting heavy here. This is an issue. Casey, they can't get off this ice.
Casey Bellamy with that big shot, but you're right. The Canadians desperately need a line change, but they managed to get two off, but Agosta remains out there at the moment. Johnson jumps into the play. USA with the big cheers from their fans as they are doing the pressing right now with 3:20 to go. If we can't settle it in the next 3 minutes and 20 seconds, we'll have five players nominated from each side to go for penalty shots. And what a way to finish this long, hard Olympic ice hockey competition. The gold medal up for grabs. We're into overtime. It's a chance for USA around the net. Cameron Azey dives in there, but just dragged back. USA doing all the pushing in the late stages of the sudden death. It's tied it up, though, very well by Laurent Rougeau, but USA have it again. Shot from the right-hand side from Lee Steckline, and we at last can take a breath with 2:41 to go. Canada and USA tied at 2-2. We're in sudden death overtime.
Getting in front of these shots here, Rougeau, outstanding sacrifice to make certain that there isn't a question being asked of Zavdos again in this overtime period.
Kessel is out on the ice. It nearly fell for it. Has now. Kessel gets in the shot from her knees. It's away by Canada and Nurse. Here comes Nurse. Can she score again against USA? She did in the group stage. She cuts back nicely there. She's upended. Of course, there'll be no call on that one. 2:20 to go. Canada want the tripping penalty. They're not going to get it. The fans, I should say, want the tripping penalty as they jeer from the stands here at the Gangneung Hockey Center. What a tournament in women's ice hockey this has been, and we've been given once again a fantastic showcase finale. 2 minutes to play, USA have it. Can USA get something off here? Bowser just biding her time, looking to tease out an opportunity instead of rushing into the big blast. The chance may be for USA right now, but it's Canada on the puck and the forward pass to Jenna. In fact, Poulin, who's dragged down to the ice. Well, we will, unbelievably, we'll go to the power play.
Well, what's been happening here is Keller has been at both ends of the rink. She's been leading the forecheck, and she tries to take Poulin out. She does it too hard, and her engine is revving too high here, and she overcooks it, competing for this puck. And it's an overtime with a minute and 35 to go, and Canada have a power play.
2 minutes, leave it.
Oh, wow. That's a brave call at this stage of the game, enforcing the rules from moment zero through to 1:35 to go. And we have four skaters against three, unless there's a goal, for the rest of this game.
It's a very brave call, and we're surprised equally as we reflect back to the Marie-Philippe Poulin situation. Slightly different, this scenario here, as this, with the player advantage for Canada, could in fact prove decisive.
So timeout, Canada, as they assess which four to send out against the three skaters from USA. 1 minute 35 to go in overtime. If US can hold out here, we'll go to penalty shots and a 2-2 scoreline.
The Americans are looking better conditioned in the last 3, 4, 5, 6 minutes of that overtime period. The Canadians, at times, were looking dead on their legs. This is a real let-off for the Canadians here to have this opportunity.
This is Johnson. Jenna is out there as well. Falling to her knees and just bad timing, really. Bad luck for Bridget Laquette. So Zabados has to gather that one. No chance of a breakout. Decline. Coyne and Fowler, the defensive trio ahead of Maddie Rooney. 1:10 to go, and Coyne uses her strength and ability to get down the other end of the ice. It was a great move because it could well have drawn a penalty if she had cut inside one more time. Not to be. Here's Johnson. Can Johnson be the hero? She's got her teammate Jenna out with her. This is Fortino. Fortino looks to line one up. Fortino has a shot. It's in front of the net. Oh, just across the goal line. Johnson took a little jab at it. So did Jenna. And that somehow went right across the goal line from Fortino's original shot. They still have it. Here comes Johnson. It's past the post. Back off the boards. And it'll be cleared by Steckline. Wow. Agosta now jumps into it as we have the dying seconds of sudden death. Can the Canadians get it at the death? They have the power play into the final few seconds, but the we're going to go to penalty shots. We are going to go to penalty shots. There's no time for Canada to get forward again. Oh, my. Oh, my. We're going to penalty shots to settle this one.
Well, why wouldn't we be? There's not been a whole lot to reflect the difference. Probably the biggest difference is we see that there's 10 shots advantage over the course of the game. After 20 minutes of extra time, we are level, Canada USA at 2, and we'll have a 3-minute break here as they come out and just scrape the ice straight down between the two goals where the players will now take the shots. This is here in front of the goal, the opportunity, that one goes wide rather, and we'll have a second look here of the panic situation where across just a touch of it, Rebecca Johnson, and it's a save made there by Maddie Rooney. Oh, you talk about a moment, and if that is in fact the door opening for the U.S. to win this in a shootout, Maddie Rooney, I'm sure, will remember that save the rest of her life. In the preliminary round, you didn't need to predetermine your shooters. And if after 5 shots you were still level with the opposition, you could actually have a repeat shooter, as this was the opening score of the game. Hillary Knight just inside the last minute of the first period. And then this play, 2 minutes inside the second, Haley Irwin gets a touch on it. And that got Canada going forward. And then this, the drop play for Captain Canada, Marie-Philippe Poulin, to finish it. And she took it in style. And from there, for a long spell, Canada looked to be taking this across the line. But the Americans stay with it and find a way to unlock the door. They aren't entirely inside yet, but they are still in and around the idea, as we're going to go to these penalty shots. The two captains discuss it with the referees. Everybody seems to be clear. It's all just about the technicality of getting the snow removed, scraped off the ice in the channel that both players will use to go and attack their respective opponents' goals. Zabados, she was picked for experience. And it's the experience of Zabados and Matty Rooney. Is that going to be an advantage for Canada? Matty Rooney has done it at the World Championships. She's not done it at an Olympic Games previously.
Well, what moments these are for not just the players, but the coaching staff. They've got to make the right decision as well of which players they'll be sending out there on the power play. What to say, if anything, to their netminders, Zabados and Rooney. We are moments away from a penalty shootout to sort out this tie game after four periods, 80 minutes. Couldn't separate Canada and US. 2-2 was the final score. It's Canada that will shoot first. It'll be Natalie Spooner on Rooney. And here comes Spooner, exploding in on the net and tried to make a little move inside. Rooney just stood her ground and it's the first X in the box. Spooner came out with speed but never got the shot off that she would have wanted. Well, control there.
Yep, that was the bottom line. Too much movement, not enough control.
As Gigi Marvin takes to the ice with a first shot for USA. Can they get the psychological and scoreline advantage? A move in front and it is in. It's into the back of the net. I thought she'd over-egg that one. Wow, it went past Zabros and Gigi Marvin scores. 1-0 US.
It's exceptional. She's got about three different moves here. Actually, she loses the handle for a moment and stays with it. And the deception of losing the puck falls in her favor.
Here comes the 31-year-old campaigner, Megan Augusta. Shoots and scores! Augusta, the best shot we've seen of the three. Into the top of the net, and Canada have their first.
Well, nothing like coming down the off wing and then just depositing it high in the hat rack as Augusta levels things at one.
Hannah Brand tries to strike back straight away for US. If she scores here, they stay ahead in the penalty shootout. It's a 24-year-old Brand who's coming in and shoots Zabados with the stop. And we are all square after two shots each.
It's a game of bluff. It's whoever moves first. Zabados does not flinch. She stays with it and she closes the wickets.
Now, what can Poulin do? The captain, the hero of the last two Olympic gold medal games, skates forward with the penalty shot for Canada. She's denied. Rooney makes a save. What a smile from the netminder. The 20-year-old comes up big, and Poulin is stopped.
Is this a moment to remember for young Matty Rooney as she blocks the Canadian captain?
Let's see what Falzer has in the bag. Backhand, save, Zabados. Big save.
Yeah, it is. She goes to the backhand, always deceptive, not a bad idea. Zabados is too big and, of course, too focused on the play. She tracks it. It's a comfortable save.
Melody Daou hasn't played through injury for so many world championships, but a huge part of these Olympic Games for Canada. Can she score? She goes. What a move!
Oh.
What a move by Daou! Exceptional! Wow!
In 1994, Peter Forsberg made this particular move famous. Is this a moment of brilliance for the Canadian here? Continual motion. They'll take the lead for the moment.
Kessel. Kessel hasn't scored in this tournament, but here she comes on the penalty shootout. What pressure on Kessel, who takes up that pressure, sets it up, and shoots into the top of the net. Wow, wow, wow. USA needed that.
Extraordinary presence here from Kessel. She has that ability, a little bit of a shoulder hit to get Zavidas to buy it, and the elevation's right on the mark.
It's two apiece. Is it down to this? Here comes Jenna. Jenna is stopped by Rooney. We are down to this. USA can win it on this shot from Hillary Knight. Is their most famous player, one of their greatest players, who has the game in her hands. It's one-on-one. It's Zavidas against Knight.
Expect Knight to shoot.
Hillary Knight for the game, shoots, and Zavidas makes a save. We're going to sudden death in the penalty shootout.
It's one for one now as Knight does shoot. In the slot, she takes a 12-footer. She doesn't elect to go for the deke. And Augusta was coming back round again. You can repeat your shooters. They're clarifying that right now. Augusta's being returned, so it's got to be reverse order. After five, we're going to have to come back again. So the last shooter for Canada, so they are going to stay with it. It is the five.
It's Jocelyn Lamoureux, though, who has this shot. Winding in on Zavidas, makes a move and slots it in. That was beautiful. So now the pressure on Megan Augusta. Rooney for the game. Wow, look at this.
So remarkable. She basically stitches Shannon Zavidas right up.
Is this the gold medal moment? Rooney against Augusta. Augusta comes in. It's a save by Rooney. Augusta can't make the shot. And USA have won their first gold medal since Nagano in the women's ice hockey. It took a penalty shot. It took sudden death penalty shots to win this one. But Canada are beaten for the first time in 24 Olympic Games ice hockey matches. USA have gold. What a moment.
The save made by Maddie Rooney on Marie-Philippe Poulin, as we said at the time, could be decisive. It is, as ultimately she makes the last one on Megan Augusta. And USA are gold medal champions at the Olympic Games again.
Well, what scenes we have here. Absolute heartbreak on the Canadian bench, but the tearful celebrations around the young netminder, Maddie Rooney, who made the big save at the end on the penalty shootout. The 20-year-old turns hero in this one for Team USA.
The interesting thing about watching Maddie Rooney's body language is that she was not overwhelmed by the moment, was she?
Not at all. Broad smiles on her face throughout the whole. Before we went to the penalty shot, she was out there having fun. She wanted to be the hero. She wanted her moment.
Well, the incredible part now for the Canadians, after enduring that additional period and then going to the penalty shot shootout, as we watch it again here from Augusta, She had the right idea. It's just that Rooney stayed with her just well enough. But the challenge now, the Canadians are going to have to wait this out as we're going to move through presentations. And their hearts are broken. Make no mistake of it, Canada, as they watch the scenes unfold here.
For so many competitors, a silver medal at the Olympics represents an absolute dream. The bronze medal in women's ice hockey means so much for the other competing nations. But it's this game that matters to these two teams just so much. And USA win it this time. They wrestle that goal back off of Canada, who've had ownership for some 20 years. USA have gold.
Well, you look at Shannon Zavados there, and I don't think that you can try and glean any sort of evaluation of the coaching decision in this one once you get to a penalty shootout. You know, it's just, it's a heartbreaking way, of course, to lose. It's the way to define and, of course, get a measured result. We've got to determine it. We can't carry on endlessly. I'm not sure that we would have, as the Canadians are running out of gas. That was visual at the end of that overtime period. But what ends up happening is just, it is a devastating way in which to have your Olympic Games tournament come to an end.
These are fantastic scenes for the US. And for the second time in her coaching and playing career, you have to feel for Laura Shuler, a player in 98 when Canada last lost in the Olympic Games gold medal game to USA. It's such a contrast of scenes. It's almost heartbreaking to see what's going on in the Canadian bench, but what a joy these smiles on the faces of USA as Hilary Knight, who came up big when it mattered in this game, getting the selfie on the ice there with her teammates.
Well, it begs the question, where were we before the selfie? And what a moment there to grab that right in the heart of the final vibrations of competition here in the women's tournament in the Gangneung Hockey Center from Pyeongchang. It's been a marvelous tournament. I love just the smile on Maddie Rooney's face. It's a joy to see that clear pleasure and equally just an athlete taking their moments when they needed to. And never at a moment did they look overcome.
We will have the medal presentations on the ice. It'll be a huge moment for USA. Let's not forget it'll be a big moment for Team Finland, who will get their moment to shine. And in spite of being silver medalists, as we saw with USA 4 years ago, it's very difficult for the silver medalists to seek solace as they stand out there trying to get their moment. Great scenes. This is wonderful for USA, who will have their moment, and further applause from the crowd as the two coaches meet at center ice. We'll have a venue ceremony here to crown USA. Huge, huge moment for them. The bronze medalists were Finland after beating OAR in the bronze medal game, and crowning glory for the legendary Noora Ratti in goal. Susanna Tapani with a big game there for Finland, who will finish in third with that big bronze medal. Canada, in spite of, well, they couldn't have kept it any closer. They will take the silver medal, and again, have been a credit to the entire program through the tournament and in this gold medal game.
It could have gone either way, as is what so clearly for anybody to understand by a full 20 minutes of extra time and then going to penalty shots as well. It came down ultimately to that shot right there.
And there is a celebration from the gold medalists, USA, after Lamoureux scored the all-important penalty shot. Rooney popping up with the all-important penalty save.
Being in and around USA Hockey over the last few years, whether it's the men's program, the women's, whether it's para ice hockey, they've had a few emotional challenges as we look at the summary of the scoring in this tournament. We got started with Knight at the end of the first period. Irwin with a great start to the second. Poulin does her job as the leader of this Canadian side. And then Lamoureux on a breakaway. That play really opens the door. And then the finishing score there, the credit for the Americans.
Who outshot Canada again, this time by 42 to 31, but there's virtually nothing between the sides for the entire 80 minutes of game time.
The Lamoureux sisters, wow. One to level it, the other one to win it in a shootout.
Another look at the downcast Canadian team who virtually could have done no more before going down in the penalty shootout and taking still the medal.
Look at the tears in some of the Canadian players' eyes, and there's a couple of things. Obviously, the devastation, the shock of the defeat, losing in the gold medal game after having four consecutive gold medals, and it's the loss of opportunity. That's a huge amount of the pain, but there's a little bit of extra fatigue in the Canadians, and when you're a little extra worn down, you're susceptible to the emotion of the situation. Of course, they just needing to have a minute or two to just reconsolidate and regroup.
A fitting end, though, to a fantastic tournament. We've got the gold medal game we deserved after the last couple of weeks of fantastic action and huge moments in these games for teams like Korea, Japan beating a European team and getting their first Olympic win in their history. OAR emerging to contest for the bronze medal when they seem down and out in the early stages.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du hockey sur glace femmes. Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the ice hockey women's tournament.
지금부터 아이스 하키 여자 종목의 시상식을 시작하겠습니다.
accueillir les médaillés. Please welcome the medalists.
여러분, 메달리스트들을 환영해 주십시오.
It's a lovely moment for Finland as well, isn't it? It shouldn't be forgotten what a big achievement, improving from fifth last time out in Sochi, and the Finnish team come out. Great moment for the bronze medalists. They'll be delighted with their achievement here in Pyeongchang.
The medals will be presented by
메달 시상자를 소개하겠습니다.
Madame Angela Ruggiero, États-Unis d'Amérique, membre de la commission exécutive du Comité international olympique, olympienne, une médaille d'or, deux médailles d'argent et une médaille de bronze. Mrs. Angela Ruggiero, United States of America, executive board member of the International Olympic Committee, Olympian, one gold medal, two silver medals and one bronze medal.
미국의 앤젤라 루지에로, 국제올림픽위원회 조정위원을 역임하고 있으며 올림픽 선수 출신으로 금메달 1개와 은메달 2개, 동메달 1개를 수상한 경력이 있습니다.
Madame Tricia Smith, Canada, membre du Comité international olympique, olympienne, une médaille d'argent. Mrs. Tricia Smith, Canada, member of the International Olympic Committee, olympian, one silver medal.
캐나다의 트리샤 스미스, 국제올림픽위원회 위원을 역임하고 있으며 올림픽 선수 출신으로 은메달 1개를 수상한 경력이 있습니다.
Accompanied by
다음은 시상품 시상자입니다.
Madame Susanna Kolbenayer, Hongrie, membre du Conseil de la Fédération Internationale de Hockey sur Glace. Mrs. Susanna Kolbenayer, Hungary, International Ice Hockey Federation Council member.
헝가리의 수잔나 콜벤하이어, 국제 아이스하키 연맹 이사회 위원입니다.
Madame Marta Zawadzka, Pologne, membre du Conseil de la Fédération Internationale de Hockey sur Glace. Mrs. Marta Zawadzka, Poland, International Ice Hockey Federation Council member.
폴란드의 마르타 차바즈카, 국제 아이스하키 연맹 이사회 위원입니다.
Médaillé de bronze. Final bronze medalists, Finland.
동메달, 핀란드.
Evelina Suompa. Isa Raunen. Rosa Lindstedt. Yeni Irikoski, Mira Yaluzo, Ella Vitazuo, Venla Obi, Linda Valimaki. Anina Rajahunta, Rika Valila, Minna Mari Tuominen, Meiri Raisanen, Petra Nieminen, Emma Nuttinen, Sani Akkala, Nora Tulus, Sara Sakkinen, Saila Sari, Michel Carvinen, Nora Ratu, Congratulations.
Thank you.
Great
work.
Susanna Tappani. Ronja Savolainen.
Great moment for the bronze medalists, Finland, to come out onto the ice, receive their medals, and some tears of joy amongst this team that have done so well to finish in third place, improving from fifth in Sochi 4 years ago. Well done to Team Finland.
Well, they earned it. They look really strong against both the Canadians and the Americans in the preliminary round.
Yes, the best of the rest, Finland. As for the Canadians, here come their
Canada
silver medals.
Silver medalists, Canada.
Canada. Canada.
Shannon Sabados. Megan Augusta. Jocelyn LaRocque. Bridget Laquette. Lorian Rougeau. Rebecca Johnston. Laura Stacy. Laura Fortino. Jennifer Wakefield. Jillian Saunier. Megan Mickelson. Renata Fast. Miloti Dem. Bailey Brand. Brianne Jenner. Sarah Nurse. Haley Irwin. Natalie Spooner. Emily Clark. Marie-Philippe Poulin. Geneviève Lacasse. Anne-Renée Desbiens. Blair Turnbull.
There aren't many silver medals which are greeted like that, but the Canadian fans here at the Gangneung Hockey Centre giving their team a huge round of applause.
Gold medalists and Olympic champions, United States of America.
Camilla, Olympic champion, Beagle.
Lee Stegline. Kayla Barnes. Haley Flanagan. Monique Levera-Marat. Emily Falzer. Megan Duggan. Haley Scarupa. Kelly Panic. Brianna Decker. Jocelyn Lamoureux Davidson. Gigi Marvin. Hannah Brandt. Hillary Knight. Casey Bellamy. Sydney Moran. Danny Cameronese. Kendall Coyne. Amanda Kessel. Nicole Hensley. Alex Rigsby. Maddie Rooney. Amanda Pelkey. Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne des États-Unis d'Amérique. Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the United States of America.
여러분, 미국의 국가 연주가 있겠습니다.
Mesdames et messieurs, les médaillés olympiques. Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
여러분, 올림픽 메달리스트들입니다.
So memories that will last a lifetime for those in this building and certainly those on the ice. Finland taking their bronze medals, Canada their silvers, and of course the gold goes to USA in an absolutely epic gold medal game. How appropriate though that they should receive their medalists from the IOC member Angela Ruggiero, herself a former US defensive player, the youngest member of the Nagano winning side back in 98, the last time that the US took gold at the Olympic Games.
Yeah, it is, and I'm sure that was by design, as she's been an IOC member now since leaving her Olympic career and a pioneer, really, in the women's ice hockey movement. Remember, women's ice hockey is only 20 years old at the Olympic Games, so these ladies very much at the forefront, all of them, in helping to grow the sport across the globe.
Still some very, very sad faces on the Canadian side. They'll, in years to come, look back at the silver medal as being absolutely a fantastic achievement. Right now, you tell any of those players that, because they've lost a game, they've lost the final game on a penalty shootout that was still level after five shots. It went to sudden death of the penalty. I mean, you can't get closer. It's incredible. The USA prevail thanks to their number 35, Maddie Rooney, the youngster coming up with a big save when it mattered most after Jocelyn Lamoureux had done the work at the other end of the ice with a nice move to put the game on the line in the penalty shootout. Rooney coming up big. We'll have photos now. There'll be some great photograph opportunities here for the photographers who've gathered down on the ice, and the US team gather center ice around the little podium there for the winning team gold medal photograph.
One thing is for sure is that this particular moment that they're enjoying right now will never be replicated again. They may win a gold medal again, but not with the same group of people.
Could well be the last time we see at the Olympic Games at least some of these players, some of them in the veteran stage of their... And 10 of these players, remember, had the heartbreak 4 years ago. So what a moment it is for that 10. And the other players, the new faces in this team, will say, well, first games, first gold medal, not bad.
Yeah, sometimes athletes that come into these situations, when they win it on their first attempt, you can have the misconception that it's going to be like this always. It's the case. This might be as good as it ever gets for even the young athletes.
So the team break after their photo op has been fantastic. The gold medal game couldn't have been more dramatic. It gave us just about everything. And we've had a terrific tournament, which has seen the US win it in the final penalty shootout to make it 3-2 on the official scoreline. Jocelyn Lamoureux with the game-winning penalty shot. Rooney with the big save, as USA will still take some time just to soak it up on the ice and celebrate in front of their fans. I think it's going to be a while until some of these players get off the ice. Great game. USA win it. The record books will show USA 3, Canada 2 after a penalty shootout, but won't go any way to explaining what's happened over the last couple of weeks. It's been fantastic, and we have a gold medal game to match the tournament as a whole, and a 3-2 victory for USA, the gold medalists.